courtroom hours. Courtroom music compilation. What's up, chat? Hi, everybody. I think you muted. Nah, you're a liar. You're a liar. You're a liar. You're a lying, lying liar who lies. Okay, okay. Ace attorney moment. Ace attorney courtroom moment. This is the wrong soundtrack, isn't it? It's supposed to be like ceremonial, I think, actually. Yeah, I have the wrong type of playlist. Dark spiritual music. No. What was the one? Hi guys, welcome to the stream. Hope you guys are doing well. Hi Noti gang. Sorry I'm late. I had some butt ass technical difficulties. Thank you for the 20 months? 29 months, Damies. Almost 30 months of subscriptions? You've been around this goddamn long? I forget I've been streaming that long. Gothic music. That'll do. That's suitably depressing. Welcome to the cathedral, my friends, my fellas. Welcome to today's ceremony. Thank you for the sub, Chunky Chat. Appreciate it. Hello, my fellow practitioners of cringe. We have gathered here today to speak. The form doesn't work. I turned it off because we have too many responses. You were supposed to fill it out before the stream, not on the stream. I should get rid of the command now that I'm thinking about it. I'm gonna get rid of that before I forget. Because that's not supposed to be visible anymore. You're not supposed to answer that. My bad. I've misled you. I've led you astray. Hi, gay people. Typical Kwite stream greeting. Hi, gay people. Hello, Father. Don't call me that. Unless it's in like a spiritual sense. Because I'm leading today's procession. Thank you for the sub, Ghoul Clouds with Prime. Appreciate it. Quite 7/8 of your audience is in LGBTQ. Why are we in church? Well, I'm glad you asked, actually. I'm glad you asked. Because today, we, and I mean you the chat as a conglomerate, are going to be having your darkest secrets revealed. This, over the course of this last week, I've asked you all to submit your deepest, darkest confessions through the Google form. I regret it. I always regret it, but I don't know. It's been especially bad. I have, not to brag, but I'm like way more famous since the last time I did this, and you guys have gotten a hell of a lot wordier. It's not open anymore, because if I left it open, it would just be piling in as I'm trying to record this stream, and it just would not be fucking possible. You guys genuinely sent me essays. I don't mean that in the way that I usually say you guys wrote essays, where it's like a big wall of text. These were legit fucking essay length, at least like a page of shit, and every single response was like that, and we got double the responses of last time, man. So I'm going to be very strict about what I read, because we're not reading all of them tonight. It's physically impossible to get it done in tonight's stream time. I'm going to be scrolling past ones that I just cannot be asked, or that seem like it, like if it gets too trauma dumpy, if it's fucking clear copy pasta shit post. I don't know. Those are the rules. Will I regret being here? Probably. Most people do. But they can't leave when they join, so it's kind of like not really up to you. I'm procrastinating reading at mice. in men for sure. For this, nice, good job. Good way of spending your Friday night. You can do it tomorrow, or the day after. Or the day after, unless it's due by then. In which case, you can't do it the day after. Wow, wait, we have fucking 800 people in here? Jeez. It still says like 300 for mine. Love the ambience. It's supposed to be like menacing, but I couldn't find the right playlist. Will we do this again? This is the again. The last time we did this was months ago. This is the again. Alright, I'm literally just stalling for the sake of my mental health. And as a Twitch streamer, you are not entitled to mental health, so... back to it. So, you may notice the, confession box has gotten a tad smaller since last time. Unfortunately... wait, what the fuck? Oh wait, I can edit this a little more. Unfortunately, Google has changed since the last time I did this shit. And fucking, there's this weird tab that I cannot get rid of. It just makes the paragraph super small, and it's annoying, and it makes reading these, like, giving me a fucking headache. But, you know, what am I gonna do? What can I do about it? Nothing. Fucking nothing. You see what I mean? Like, there's, like, when I zoom in big time, it's just this big fucking untitled form bullshit. Like, I can't get rid of it. It makes me so sad. Like, I'm actually crying right now. Alright, time for me to show you the first sinner. I'm not gonna lie to you. It gets really bad really early. I used to masturbate onto birds at a local park. Not a thing I'm particularly proud of, but I became quite good at it. I was taking zinc supplements, so I was shooting massive loads, and it became something of a sport for me. For anyone interested, here is your best strategy. I don't care. Look how long it goes for! Look how long! Fucking great! That's definitely a copypasta. That's definitely a copypasta. Somebody definitely got that from somewhere else. But I hope you know what we're in for tonight. Good God. How do these people live on after doing that? Because no one actually... at least the person sending this didn't actually do it. They just copy and pasted it off of Reddit. Let's see if any of these are quite originals. I have two confessions, actually. I will say prepare yourselves because it's kind of crazy. There's a high bar for crazy in this chat, okay? I'm not gonna say you won't top it because I have been proven wrong before. Confession one. This took place when I was in preschool. Not good. I was about 3 or 4 at the time, maybe 5. But at this time, I had anger issues, and I mean very bad anger issues. To this day, we were on the playground, and I was talking to my friend. I'm just sitting there eating my animal crackers, and this kid comes over and starts messing with me and my friend. He wasn't doing anything bad, just making funny faces. My 3, 4, or 5-year-old self got pissed, I don't know why. So I had this jacket with a metal zipper, and I was thinking about what weapon to use, and that's when the jacket came in mind. I took off the jacket and hit the kid as hard as I could with the zipper, and then his head started to bleed and he started crying. That's when I ran into this tunnel and hoped they wouldn't find me. Spoiler alert, they did, so I'm in the office and the teacher told the lady at the front desk to tell my parents. Now I'm panicking because I'm getting spanked at this age with a belt. I'm crying. My dad walks in. I don't know if the lady has dementia, but she forgot to tell my dad, so I got lucky. I haven't told my parents today. That's really tame for this. That's really tame for my chat. If 2 is not anything a lot crazier than that, we have, like, had multiple attempted murders here, in like, from children, nonetheless. This is pretty standard play so far. Alright, confession 2. I once killed 2 birds with 1 stone. Well, rock. Do you mean literally? Is this, like, literal? So, animal murder is also not new for this stream. Remember the cat in the microwave? Very, very fun stuff. So my Nana lives in the woods, so there's a lot of wildlife there. One day, I was doing what any normal kid would do, throwing rocks to see how high they'd reach. So while I'm doing this, a flock of birds fly by, and they're pretty close to the ground. So I throw this rock, and it goes pretty high, but the next thing I know, I hear 2 loud squawks, and then 2 birds fall to the ground. Fucking collateral, dude. Good shit. Good kill feed. I don't know why, but I panic, so I take the birds and feed them to my Nana's dog. Oh my god. See, that's the fucked up part. Kids throw rocks. They're idiots. They throw rocks at water, they throw them in the air, they throw them at each other, because they don't understand what they do. You hit a bird. It happens. Then you fed them, you pick them up and fed them to the dog, dude! Oh, I'm in pain. I'm in severe pain at all hours of the day. I'll say, this is still middle of the pack Kwite confession. This is still like middle tier, I think. We've definitely seen worse, but you're not saying nothing here. Hi, this is the same person from the cupcake story, if you remember. I don't. Where the bell would ring everyone to go out the yard, and I hid in the bathroom, waited until everyone left, and took a bite out of everyone's cupcakes. See, that's like a really funny, unique, and gross confession that isn't like life-endingly bad. That's some stupid shit a child would do. Yeah, I remember it now. I have a lot more stories of me causing havoc in my classroom. Oh, so you're a repeat offender. Doing that same thing with hiding in the bathroom. I convinced all the kids in my classroom that there was a ghost. I don't care about ghost stories. I'm sorry, I'm skipping. This goes on too damn long anyways. You know, guys, it might be a good preventative measure to just down a White Claw right now. Like, I'm a decent way into this. Like, just as, like, you know, I'm self-medicating on this one. It might just be, like, a good coping mechanism. Yep, it's going down. Not chugging, but a big good sip. Okay. Mentally prepared. Not read it, fucker. I'm about to. Oh. Okay. I can do this. I found my brother watching me at the strip club. When I was 20, I dropped out of university because I wasn't happy with what I was doing. Engineering. I don't know why, but like, I wasn't happy with what I was doing. And then you put engineering. Like, it'll just make us immediately understand. Oh yeah, I get that. And I was like, fuck it, I'll figure something out. I moved back in with my parents, who were understandably upset at me for giving up on my future, and my brother was also living there because he never went to uni in the first place. He was always out of the house and never told us where he was going. He would throw shit at us if we bothered him, so we never tried to talk about it. About 4 months in, I decided to get a job. I keep seeing TikToks about strippers getting hella cash. If I'm gonna be honest, I was really invested. We live in a small city, so there were still other jobs I could have gotten, but you needed experience. This was when I really started to regret dropping out. I was super frustrated and desperate, so I went with the stripper job without telling my parents. The next 2 to 3 months, nothing really happened, and I made good money. One night, I was exhausted. I was ready to leave, but kept the show going just for extra money. That's when I noticed faces from the back. It was normally dim in the club, so I wasn't usually able to see most people, but sometimes the strobe lights would go wild. Basically, I saw my brother and his friend straight up watching and grinning at me from the corner of the club while drinking, and I almost felt like vomiting. I ran to the back as soon as I saw him, and I don't even know how long it had been until I just decided to leave. The anxiety got to me really bad. I don't know how long he had been doing that, and my gut told me to quit. Never confronted him about it, nor have I told my parents this all happened 1 year ago. Christ, man. Holy God. Holy shit, we're still doing these? We've only been live for 10 minutes. We started late, Jillian. We had technical issues. Do you think that, like, could have been a one-off, like, poor timing thing? Like, he's like, oh, fuck, I didn't know my sister worked here. I hope that was just an awful coincidence. But God, I thought you weren't doing them? Nah, bro, they get big views and big viewers. Ugh. Yeah, I mean, I'm sorry that happened to you. I betrayed a girl who was kind to me. This sounds like an animated story, Tom. I'm just going to skip. This is quite literally my fourth confession. I'm addicted. Anyways, this took place at a family reunion. It happened a few years ago. I know you're probably wondering what it... I'm getting to that fuck face. I don't have time for tongue-in-cheekness. I'm just going to start... I'm not trying... No, I'm not... I can't do trauma dumping right now. I'm getting traumatized right now. In sixth grade, I was sort of friends with this guy in my class. We shared a locker, and since our names alphabetically were next to each other, we would be sat together in most of our classes. We sort of grew to know each other due to this. Anyways, there were rumors that he had a crush on me. Everyone started to tell me it and tease me about it. It started to become annoying because I only saw him as a friend. One day we were playing dodgeball in gym, and this one annoying kid that I still hate to this day was teasing me and saying me and that one kid were dating. I was annoyed and told him, "We aren't dating. I don't like him. He's ugly." Fuck up, dude. Fuck up. You said he was a friend. You didn't have to do him like that. Now, the key thing is that I called this kid ugly. Me saying this spread quickly, and the guy that had a crush on me was visibly sad. After gym, we went to our homeroom, and this popular girl was talking to me about it. And keep in mind, this guy is sitting right next to me, and I call him ugly again. Double down. Never admit you're wrong, bro. Typical middle schooler playbook. You sixth graders are all like this, man. I never did shit wrong. I'm gonna dig this hole and die in it. I feel so horrible for this. I'm going into my junior year of high school and I want to apologize to this kid. I'm conflicted because I don't think I should bring it up. Maybe he forgot about it. Haven't spoken to him in years. I'm starting to transition and that can make the situation more awkward. I don't know, I feel bad and I want to apologize, but it could be weird. I mean, I don't know, I've done things in middle school that I went on to apologize for in high school. Like, if you genuinely feel bad about it and feel like he deserves an apology, I just bite the bullet. It's not going to make it any worse. For you, at least. And, like, he'll at least know that... Fuck. Just be honest, I guess. That's all. I had a dream that you hit, like, 20,000 million subs, and me and, like, other people... This is a dream. This didn't happen. This is not a confession. This is me like, I had this funny dream last night that me and Drake were kissing. It wasn't a dream for me, though. When I was younger, me and my brother had to take turns on the N64, and I never got to complete games like Super Mario 64 or Pokemon Snap because my brother kept deleting my saves. So I hated when he wanted to play because I had to watch him like a hawk to make sure he didn't delete anything. My brother was still young at the time. He was still at the age where he was wetting the bed. So like what, 19, 20? Right? That's like around the age you still do that, I think. Where he was wetting the bed, and every time he wet the bed, he wasn't allowed to play the N64 for the day. So one morning, I had this idea. I waited until my brother woke up and went into the living room to watch TV, and then I went into the kitchen, filled a jug up with water, went into his room, pulled back his bed sheets, and poured the water onto his mattress to make it look like he wet the bed. And it worked. My brother was punished by not being allowed to play the N64, and I got it all to myself. So whenever I wanted to play it for the day, I made it look like he wet the bed, and there are times where I legit did that every morning for 3 weeks straight. And the worst part is that I legitimately did this for 3 years, even though about a year my brother had stopped actually wetting the bed. I told my mom this story. She had no idea that I was doing this and really thought my brother was still wetting the bed for like 2 years after. Oh my fucking god, man. You did him so goddamn dirty. But holy shit, that is so fucking smart. I don't know. I think the little brother started it. I think the little brother started it. He shouldn't have been deleting your save files, man. I understand. I let some, like, one of my friend's little snot-nosed brothers borrow a game of mine once, and he deleted a save I had, like, 100 hours on Pokemon in. But, like, except I couldn't retaliate. Because that's not even my little brother. That's just, like, some little shit who did that to me. And, I mean, like, what was really the consequence? He has to go outside? Also, I want to say, why were they punishing the little brother for wetting the beds? Like, it's not, like, something you control. It just kind of happens, right? Like, that doesn't seem like something you can punish out of someone. So, this really comes down to bad parenting. It always comes back down to the parents. What were you thinking? Thank you for the Prime sub. Lover by Taylor Swift, appreciate it. Alright. I purposefully hit a girl with a volleyball in the face for targeting me. Context, this was in one of the teams we were playing against for the tournament. She was intentionally hurting my teammates and other teams as well. She's being a total bitch and insulted me and my team. Thank you for the sub, Raccoon Fizz, appreciate it. Do I still have the... I do. I still have the live polls option if we want to run those. During our match, she was targeting some of the girls on my team and hitting them with the ball when she was serving. She'd give them dirty looks to me and the rest of the girls. Of course, I was the one with a kind of bad temper. Thank you for the Prime sub, Lenny Broccoli. After hurting some of the girls on my team, mind you, we were very short girls and all of them hated violence, so of course they would not say a single thing to the coaches. The other team looked to be about 2 or 3 years older, and we were in fifth grade. She continued this for 2 out of 3 sets. I was pissed by the end of the third. When she served at one of the girls, we did the whole thing, but then she hit the ball into my face, directly at my face. So I in retaliation, I served it back as hard as I could at her face. She got a bloody nose, and it was pouring like it didn't stop for minutes. Am I wrong? No. That's hardcore. Good. Fuck them. They were older than you anyways. They had it coming. Picking on the weak and then turning, like, fuck it around and find out. Slay. Pussy slay, queen. I was a really weird kid. But I was also, like, sadistic. Okay. First confession I got is that when I was a kid, my backyard had this massive rose bush that was beautiful. But in my little baby mind, I decided to team up with my dog and eat every single rose off the bush. I mean, mashing these whole flowers in my jaws and spitting some of them back out onto our concrete patio. And by the time my parents found me, our rose bush was completely destroyed. Aside from me creating flower paste as a toddler, I'd also do terrible things to bugs I would catch in my front yard. Like, specifically grasshoppers. I would bury them in sand and then dig them back up and, like, shove small sticks in their mouth. The scariest thing I would do is tear off their back legs and put them onto the grass, leaving them completely crippled and jumpless. How will they join the NBA now, dude? What the fuck? Okay, so it seems like there's a lot more coming, so I'd like to say, I don't think that doing things to bugs specifically as a kid makes you a psychopath, because, you know, we still, like, kill bugs as adults, right? And as a kid, you don't really have a full concept of, like, pain or, like, the violence you're inflicting onto other things. It's, like, a thing kids sometimes have and grow out of. So I don't think... I think the rosebush shit is just, like, dumbass kid funny story. And, like, it was, like, it showed you had a good bond with your dog. You got on well with an animal. So thumbs up. That's a good sign. Aside from that, I was young and looked at my shitty uncle without knowing at the time he was shitty. Instead, I drowned him in a sink. Based? He laughed it off and said it'd be pretty hard since he's big, to which little four-year-old me replied, I could drown you in the sink if you were a mouse. Scared the shit out of my uncle and he called me creepy, made his sister and my mom laugh. That's just like a hard-ass line, man. I don't know, I don't think any of the stories in this were too bad. You see, you're, like, if this was the only things I knew about you, A-okay in my book. I forgot to confess something else. I will say this one's fucked up. Again, high bar to clear if you're going to claim your confession's fucked up. I have this best friend. We met online about 1 year and 7 months ago. He liked me 3 months into our friendship. His friends pressured him into confessing, and when he did it, it was very awkward and we broke up same day. Finally, after 2 more months, I feel for him, but at the same time, he already had a boyfriend, so I wanted to cover up my feelings. I said I like one of his other friends, and he's happy for me, even giving me advice to help me get with her. So about 3 to 4 Oh, thank you for the 50 bits, Neko Trap, appreciate it. God fucking damn it. Why did you have to attach that message to bits? I hate you. She did like me, but needed time. So 2 weeks later, she said yes, and we got together. Thing is, I didn't like her. Still love my best friend. The New Year's, he confessed that he loved me. And I said yes and immediately broke up with my at-the-time girlfriend. She's sad, and I felt bad because I lied to her over and over again, telling her I loved her. But I haven't told anyone, not even my boyfriend. Yeah, but we've been together for 7 months now, and I'm very happy. Me and my ex are still friends, and his ex still hates me. Have a good day, Kwite in chat. I mean, as long as you broke up with them first, I guess. I mean, like, fuck, man. I want to say, like, all this relationship stuff, you're in middle school, I don't care. Like, you'll get, like, high school? You're, like, still a kid, but, like, the habits you form there may carry on a little longer. If this was, like, some elementary middle school shit, I don't give a fuck. This is a strange one. I was watching this thing called Cosplay Chess, who for the sake of this I'll call Jaryong. Why did I'm not calling him that. I'll call him Jared. What, like, when you guys make fake names, could you make them easy for me? Thank you for the 100 bits, Cyberwasp, appreciate it. I'll call Jared because it sounds funny. Quick explanation, Cosplay Chess is chess, but instead of pieces you use nerds dressed up as fictional characters. Before the game started, there were 2 announcers calling up people to get onto the parts of the board. There were some cool things that looked neat and all that. What'd you expect from watching? After 10 minutes, more people getting onto the board. Someone with an Inuyasha cosplay rolled onto the board in a wheelchair, which I wasn't expecting at all. And I'll be completely honest here, I let out one of the longest and loudest laughs I ever did in a while. I have not been able to forgive myself for actually laughing at a paraplegic since that day. But honestly, this is probably pretty tame compared to almost every other confession. Yeah. Oh, man. I have, like, a dumbass toddler confession I can make that relates to this. I don't think it's as bad as this, because I'm pretty sure you were way older than me when this happened. Like, how are you going to be let on the stage for that? What? Bruh. So, I'll say it like this. When I was, like, 5 or 6... I did not know what Tourette's was. So somebody who had Tourette's, like, I think they, like, worked at Target, and I was sitting in the little shopping cart. They, they made like it, you know, they had an involuntary tick where they like yelled and it hurt my ears and I was like, ow, stop it. And they're like, I can't. And apparently I told him, yes, you can. Which is not great. Not great to say to someone with Tourette's. Really fucked up, and I felt bad about it ever since. But, you know, you give some, you get some. You know, I feel like it's fair. Yeah, ain't quite. 5-year-old Kwite was a piece of shit, dude. Absolutely fucking absolute monster. Absolute piece of shit. I've gotten better since then. I've really learned the error of my ways. I have friends with Tourette's. Come on! Oh, God. Oh, God. It's like one of... It's really embarrassing, but it's relevant. When I was younger, my younger sister and I had Pokemon X and Y. Now, H and I would get into fights, and she especially had terrible control over her emotions. That being stated, let's get on to why I brought this up. In my game, I had a shiny level 100 Rayquaza, max friendship. I traded up for this boy, and he was my pride and joy, the powerhouse of my team. H knew this. One day, we got into an argument, and she steals my 3DS and releases him. See, that's what I would be confessing. If I did that shit, I would be confessing that in the form. She'd done this before, actually, but this time she saved the game. Child me was heartbroken. In revenge, I took her game and released her Xerneas, which was her absolute favorite Pokemon, and I saved the game. I mean, that was her favorite, but it was not worth as much as your Rayquaza. Like, you traded up. He was shiny, level 100, max friendship. Like, that is a valuable commodity. She can get a Xerneas by replaying the game, dude. Like, that, it's not an equal trade. I think she deserved that and more. Thank you for the Prime sub, Kane. She noticed the next day she confronted me, not wanting to escalate into a fight. I told her the game glitched. To this day, with her and I at 1621, I have not told her what I actually did it. She deserved it. She lost her beloved rainbow horns. I will never tell her the truth. You said that if she sees this video and she sees the nickname of her Xerneas, she's gonna know what you did. You, like, self-report. You could have been like, if she brought this up to you and you didn't say nicknames of the Pokemon, you could have been like, that's a crazy coincidence, what the fuck? The ages are the same too, and their names have the same first letter? You said the name of the goddamn Pokemon, dude! What were you thinking? The girl still deserved it. I'm not going back on this. I have two, I'm not sure which one cannot be shared. Well, we'll quickly scroll if it's bad. We'll quickly scroll if it's bad. I have two, but I'm not sure which one can be shared, so here, on the school bus going home, I wanted to share a friend a cursed paragraph of a fanfiction I read. I know how that goes. To make it for fun, we decided to voice act it. Mind you, this was intended for mature audiences. We also decided to act it out, like whispering in each other's ears, nuzzling? While we were acting it aloud, this kid behind us recognized the names of the characters and decided to talk to us about them. We were both so fucking embarrassed, and I just handed her the computer to finish reading it. Just like, you got caught, man. Just got caught. No other way to say it. You took an L. Like, that's a massive L. I'm glad they meant acted it out and not in a literal sense. Like, jeez. When I was really young, my mom allowed me to download this app on her phone, and it was basically an app filled with activities for kids my age. There's a camera feature to take pictures, and my brother and I were messing with it, taking pictures of stuff, and I don't even remember how it crossed my mind, but I took... No. I'm finishing the drink, by the way. I'm finishing the drink. I think I have to finish reading it for the sake of YouTube viewers. I ended up taking pictures of my brother's private parts. My mom found out and went ballistic. Okay, Flinders, it's there for the edit. I'm sorry, but I'm going to be skipping self-harm mentions. It's nothing personal, it's just, like, for the sake of the content. Like, gross-out humor is one thing, like, potentially triggering stuff is another. There was a person there was this person who tried to convince me and my friend into hating each other because they didn't like that my friend had other friends other than them. And after we confronted them with a 3-page essay on why they sucked and evidence of the lying and attempted gaslighting, we were still not satisfied. After that, my friend realized that the person didn't change their Genshin Impact login. See, I could have told you this person was bad news. They have a Genshin Impact login. They have been saving up the in-game currency for months. We logged into their account and used all of the currency and got rid of all of their really good in-game items. Technically, my friend did most of the work because the person refused to do stuff on their own account without my friend. Your friend played Genshin Impact 2? Bad news. Cut him off. You are an unreliable narrator. You are an unreliable narrator. You cannot be trusted. Not reading that. Awful start. As a middle school child, I was bullied by a bunch of 8th graders who lived in the area. I tried getting them to stop harassing me because everyone always told me that boys do that when they're interested in you, so they didn't help. Whoever made that fucking saying up, oh, boys are will just bully you when they're into you, you're a fucking idiot. Like, holy shit, you are like the stupidest motherfucker on Earth. I hope you're not on Earth anymore, genuinely. Like, you know how much grief you have caused to people? Fuck no. They were dumb enough to believe it for a while and stayed away. Eventually, they didn't believe it anymore, and they wanted to physically... Wait, what did they say? You convinced them you were possessed? Oh, you gave yourself the cheese touch. Genius. Eventually, they didn't believe it anymore, and they wanted to physically hurt me for tricking them. So after going apartment to apartment, hiding from them, I ran toward local Fairways parking lot. I found bad eggs behind the dumpster and threw some of the pavement in front of them to warn them to back off. Instead, they got distracted and left me alone. An employee apparently called the cops, and when a cop came to the door asking if we knew about it, I told the cop and it was them, and what apartment to find them in. I was never bothered by the boys again after that. That's some masterful social engineering. I gotta clap. People be like, aw, they like you when you have a bruise. If they like me, why are they hurting me? Like, even if that is true, horrible precedent to set emotionally. Like, never tell someone that someone hurting you is a sign that they like you, because that'll fucking that will stick, and it'll like form some very unhealthy expectations moving up. Don't I know? God. TLDR, as a five-year-old, I got high off my mind via Creek Snickers. What is that? I gotta Google that. So you legit just like smoked a Snickers bar? When I was little, my mom didn't want me going outside, so I wouldn't get run over by a truck on a highway. However, since I was a little shit, one time I decided to tempt my fate at the outside world. I headed out to the near creek I lived by. At this creek, there was an electrical pole. On the pole, someone had left an open but not eaten bag of Snickers. I knew my duty. I ate every single Snicker in the bag. After inhaling upwards of 4,000 calories into my small, potable body, I realized I had done something wrong. Left the bag of opened and eaten Snickers there on the ground, walked back to my house, somehow without my mom noticing I'd left, and promptly shat my little baby brains out. My mom's only question is how I found too much chocolate, but she didn't realize it had been outside of the home until like 4 months later. I'm the asshole, but should I repent for my past sinful shits? Okay, so you got sick off of it. I'm failing to realize how you got blasted, like just straight high. I thought your whole thing was gonna be like, yeah, it turns out they were like edibles. And I was like, what? What? So not high, just sick. Just you had the shits. That's different. I had a crush on this guy named Kevin. He's super cute. Thank you for the sub. Please, I've been here for days for the Prime sub, so it's free. I had a crush on this guy and named him Kevin. He's super cute and adorable. He played baseball. He's on a team with one of the guys that I liked but stopped liking him because he got a girlfriend. I got introduced to him through someone named Bobby. Bobby has Kevin's number and we start talking. After a month and a half of talking, he confessed to me. But before that, he told me he was best friends with my ex. Then after he learned that I liked him too, he sent me super cute like TikTok saying, "You're the only one I love." This is very like high school shit. "And you're the only one I think of," and other BS like that. So we went to a camp and I've never heard from him again. So a few weeks ago, I sent him a text saying, "I hate you so much. If you actually liked me, you would not have ghosted me." Turns out he goes to my cotillion, and I'm seeing him next year. I recently heard from a friend that he was a player. So, quite any advice what I should say? I don't fucking know. What do you want me to do about it? Like, what? What do you mean? What am I supposed to tell you to do here? Fucking, oh, confess your feelings. I don't know. I don't fucking care. Like, this is some middle school shit, man. I can't tell you jack about this. I've never fucked anyone in my life. What? Jesus Christ. Awful, awful priorities, man. Back in 2016, my family went on a camping trip and we brought my cousin along. it was in this park type thing, but it wasn't altered very much by people, so it was just trees. The only bathrooms were the bushes or the stalls that were far from our spot. I get up in the morning and I have to piss. My parents take me to the stalls because fuck the bushes. They're huge spider webs and those huge ass mosquito eaters. Then you're the 50 bits. You see, I'm a huge pussy, and I'm terrified of bugs. I don't use the bathroom, and instead, when we go back to our spot, I take a cup with me into my tent and do my thing in the corner where my cousin sleeps, because fuck it. I don't realize how much I had in me, and it spills over on the edge of her pillow and sheets. She doesn't know what happened. Also, there was one time I ripped a hand. Okay, I don't care about the second one. I don't care about the second one. Let me tell you guys a very, very important lesson for the sake of peeing in water bottles. I tried it once in my life because I was really curious if I could, like, fill it up. Your pee, your standard pee, if you saved it up, will always overflow out of the bottle. You, like, your typical pee will be more than a water bottle. I know it seems like less because you're used to peeing in a toilet bowl, but the fact that it's bowl-shaped and has water in it to dilute it is like, going to trick you and change your expectations. I'm telling you, trust me on this. I learned this very young. I think I was 13 when I peed in a bottle. And I was like, very curious. How many times did you try? Literally once. I did it once, got a little on my fingers, and I was like, and I never wanted to do it again. I learned the hard way, and I never did it again. The lesson stuck, didn't it? I learned from my mistakes, and I'm telling you so you don't have to learn from them. When I was about 9 years old, I had a friend that, for this story, I'll call E. Me and her were pretty close, and one day I slept over her house. We had a pretty fun day until she fell asleep before me. E's bedroom was right next to her mom's, only connected by a thin apartment wall. That night, I couldn't sleep at all. However, E's mom didn't know this. At 2 a.m., I saw her peek her head in the room. Maybe 5 minutes later, I heard her and her dad talking. For the first, I wasn't sure what the sounds coming from the mom's room were. 10 minutes, though, it finally hit me. Couldn't get up for fear of waking my friends, me seeing something that would make me need to get therapy. Had to stay put in the boiling hot room, listening to moans in the room right next to me. Fell asleep an hour later, and the morning was extremely awkward for me. I mean, yeah, you don't bring that up. I mean, like, I don't think that parents should have been, should have been fucking, especially when there was, like, another, like, their daughter's having a sleepover. But it happens. But that also is not something, like, you tell them, because they obviously, like, why would you let them know? Like, no point. Don't do it. You will not gain anything from telling them. They will just feel bad. You will feel worse. It helps literally nobody. The only people who know are the people in this Twitch chat. All 1,000 of them. 1,000 people know now. And however many people see this on YouTube. My elementary school was shit, to say the least. It would only make sense that all the teachers were bad too. I stole so much from those little bitches the administration hired to torture us poor gremlins. In the second grade, I stole a really nice piece of candy from her. It was her birthday gift from the principal. My bag was right behind the desk where the teacher sat down, but did the logical thing a 7-year-old would do and picked it up and threw it into my bag. You were the golden child, so I never got suspended. I plagiarized, your child did bad shit, and whatever. If it's just innocent confessions, like, ooh, man, I did some shithead, like, little kid things, it doesn't even stimulate me anymore. Like, it's just nothing. It's nothing. It's like, yeah, you and everybody else, bro, I ate crayons too. When I was in elementary school and middle school, I had a short temper. In sixth grade, I was in math class, and we had M&M for math reasons. We ate them, and at the end of the class, except my black friend, and I said, why? Because they're the... My friend thought it was funnier than it was, but some other kid, we call him Grant, I had my next class when I said I was racist over and over again down the hall the way to our class. So sat down in our next class, I got up and I trapped him in between the wall, the desk, and his chair and punched his face till his nose broke. We both got expelled since we had fought numerous times in the past. Everyone loved me because Grant would grope girls in the hallways. It was an all-around asshole. This was 10 years ago and I have learned to control my temper since then. Also, Grant is in prison for rape. Well, I guess somebody got the last laugh. I guess. Like, there's, like... I personally... I guess if your friend was okay with it, like, it's not my place to tell him, but, like, jeez. Ugh. So I used to have this old friend group. Me, my older sister, my best friend, his older brother, and two other friends, a boy and a girl. When I was 12, they all got me this violin for Christmas because my older sister was playing the piano, and they thought it'd be nice for us to spend more time together. Time passes, and we both learn how to play a song real well for a duet. The night of the show was the worst night of my life. We fought on top of the stairs. She's angry at me, and I'd never seen her so angry. I threw my violin down the stairs. That made her more angry. I tried to get past her down the stairs, but she got in the way, and I accidentally pushed her. My friend just got there and saw it all. We were panicked, and we thought we were going to jail. But then my friend decided we should fake it as suicide? Wait, so your sister died when you pushed her down the stairs? You're saying, oh, it's literally fucking Omori. It's, God damn it, I haven't beaten the game yet, prick. I have not beaten the game yet. You asshole, you fucking dick. You motherfucker, I hate you so much. I hate you so more. God damn it. I wouldn't have known it was an Omori spoiler if it wasn't for you fuckers. You spoiled it for me. It's chat's fault. I need to direct my anger somewhere. I can't just take personal responsibility. You will never catch me doing that shit. I will deflect and dig my grave until the day I die. I framed my cat once. When I was still in middle school, I actually liked PE and almost never brought water. The one time I brought a water bottle is my little brother's. Fast forward to me absolutely slamming the water bottle on the floor of the PE room, trying to do a bottle flip with a high-quality water bottle, and the cat breaks. I knew I was going to get in trouble, so waiting until it was night when everyone was sleeping and staged the crime scene. I matched up the water bottle with the counter, then placed it in a way to where it looked like it had been knocked off. After that, I placed a little way away from the bottle like it had fallen off and the bottle had chipped. After it was completed, I poured some water on the floor in front of the bottle to make it look like it had spilled when it fell. I asked my dad about it days later, and he told me the cat knocked the bottle off the counter. Fuck. That's like CIA level shit, man. You got a career in like breaking in like and destroying governments, man, and like breaking up democratically elected governments. You got a future in that. Hey Hoodie, how you doing? I was the same person that stuck the rabbit in the washer. Anyways, a little after, I was playing around with them and my sister had pulled the tail of Whitey. White and E is the pronunciation. And when I asked her to stop, she ended up biting the rabbit's tail? That rabbit has been through hell, dude. She is just not safe in your family. She was not safe in your family. You guys should not have had a rabbit. Christ! You should not have owned a rabbit. I asked what happened. She told them it was me and I got in trouble. A week later, we were playing around and they took the rabbits at the cage. I kept telling them to put them back, but they wouldn't listen. They ended up making a huge mess. So what I did was I took some of the rabbit's toys and stuck them in a drain and left the sink on. So when my parents asked why the garage caved in, I told them the kids were the last to play with the rabbit stuff, and they ended up getting in trouble and having to work off the water bill. Oh my god. Good fucking god. Yeah, no, you motherfuckers should not have been allowed to be around that small animal. Like, so, like, you should not have been around them. This is really embarrassing, but pretty much my cousins made me make out with a toy dog. Well, I'm gonna say, at least it wasn't a real one. We were in a mall, and our parents were changing, so we entered a changing room near them and played. I don't remember how it came to this, but eventually I was laying down on the bench, and my cousin had her toy boo dog, or whatever the fuck they were called, all over me. I wish I was joking. She had it all over my face and in my mouth. I remember how gross it felt to have fake fur in my mouth. It was uncomfortable. Meanwhile, my sister and cousin watched and guarded the door? Fast forward a couple weeks, and my cousin says that the dog died of cancer, and I played along saying, did he take the medicine I sent him? Thanks to the sub, OCD on life, and pretending to be sad about it. Years later, I still think of that moment a lot and pray to God they don't remember or have told anyone about that. Does it matter? Because you just told all of us. We don't know who you are. But... I need to get this off my chest. I know it's horrible and I don't expect any closure or forgiveness. You opened this like a YouTube apology. This can't be good. But I really need to tell someone, anyone. For the past few months, maybe in a year, I've been obsessed with some rather concerning Okay, guys. Guys, I'm gonna... Before I finish reading this, I'm going to run an ad break and get more alcohol. I feel like I've earned it. I feel like I've earned it. Oh my god. Actually, the best. All right, I'm back. Okay, I can do this. Is milk a broth? No. Okay, where do we leave off? I've been obsessed with some rather concerning content. I've not been entirely obsessed, and I'm not saying it takes up all my time, but it's enough of an obsession it's concerning. I eagerly await new content every few days and keeps tabs on when this stuff is planned to go out. I feel like this is going to be a subversion. Like, it's going to be something, like, really normal or funny. Because the buildup in this feels comedic. But it's going beyond just the content itself. I've been spun into a downward spiral, and I can't keep doing this. It's not healthy. I've joined a related Discord server. Considered making some fan content of my own. It's going to be League of Legends, isn't it? And even have started talking more frequently with like-minded individuals. I really hate to say it, and I know it's... unforgivable, but I'm a quiet mirror. You're so funny! You're so fucking funny! That's you! Oh my fucking god! You're literally the funniest person I've ever met! Shut the fuck up! Holy shit! My brain... Like, I thank you for the sub, Legbird. I don't even need to put a gun in my mouth for, like, my brain to explode like a bullet has just gone through it. I can't fucking do it! It will tell it my brain is going to telekinetically explode like it's in Scanners. Dude! This is somehow worse than what I thought it would be! I should have guessed it would be me. I should know you guys better by now. I'm glad I got the alcohol. Is he okay? What do you think? Oh, you did get me. I'll give you that. That was good. The buildup was good. Like, you had me. Someone said worse than a CP confession. Dude, no! Oh, how did you not see this coming? I've been kind of, like, glazed over this last hour. I feel like it's fair to not be 100% cognitively there after everything I've been going through. Oh, I'm so sorry. Deep breaths. Honestly, L quiet for not realizing it. I got gut, it's true. Okay, I've got two buckle-ups for the second one because it's a bumpy ride. One, before my dad died, like literally before the news got out, I wished that he was dead and said that I'd do anything to see him dead because I was pissed my parents were getting divorced. Still blame myself for that, but you know, it'd be like that sometimes. It wasn't your fault. That's a shit coincidence, but it ain't your fault. Two, I've had a crush on a guy that bullied me and makes fun of me for like a year. I don't get off to that shit, but he's told me to kill myself many, many times, and I... Oh, God. Fast forward, I'm talking with my friend. She says that you'll like me back, and I'm like, what? Because who in the fresh fuck tells their crush to do that? But we still talk. Good God. Did he say sorry? Good God. I hope you're getting help. I hope you're, like, in a healthier mind state now. Like, I'm wishing the best for you, whoever you are. Hi, streaming, Kwite. Hope you're good. Here we go. So, I did a job for a guy, right? I got put with two other people, cool dude, and a very nice lady. Fell in love with a guy, but that's for a different gayer story. Wish it was me. And we were, wish I was the somebody falling in love with another man. Just like, it's like, damn, and when is it my turn to be happy? We may or may not have set a part of a small forest on fire and burnt it down. It wasn't connected to or nearby anything else, so it was kind of contained. We put it out, but damn, that forest is not good. It is not good as of now. Still pass by it sometimes when I'm going to the part of town it's in. Good memories, but also this literally haunts me. I wasn't physically part of it, but damn, I do be a witness. No one knows it was us either. They assumed it was just because it's hot as hell there sometimes. TLDR, set forest on fire, got off free, haunted by this nightly. I mean, but, like, you didn't do it. It wasn't, like, you. You just happened to, yeah, be gay, do crimes. I do be a witness. You do be an accessory to arson. That's true. When I was 9, I was hanging out with a friend for the day in his at his grandma's house, and being 9 and having nothing else to do, we wandered down the stairs to the basement and started looking through old boxes that used to belong to his deceased uncle, who was temporarily living there while they died. Before they died, not while they died, fuck. That would have been so bad. Well, we came upon a colorful looking red- oh, no. I hope it's just the first Iron Man film, hence the red and yellow theming. I hope it was just a pirated movie of the Marvel variety. So being children, we plugged it into the computer to see what things it had. Well, we... Skipping the rest of that one. Done. Done. Over. Oh my God. Oh. What in the fresh fuck? Found a magazine my dad had, and it was New Girls and Motorcycles. Ended up going to the bathroom and hiding it, and just reading it all the time. When I went to the bathroom, keep in mind, I have never felt attraction to a woman. I am a gay trans male. I keep looking at these women, and one day my dad walks into my room and asked if I had seen his magazines. Of course, me being literally 12 at the time, I said no and had to change my plan. Went to the bathroom later on when my dad was working and hid the magazine behind my brother's bed frame. you set him up. You framed him. My dad, after work, asked my brother if he'd seen it. He says no, but I came to the rescue and told my dad I'd seen the magazine while he was working behind my brother's bed frame. So my dad will always think it my brother, who is 10. Fucked up. Fucked up. In second grade, I did a giant MLM scam in our school. Okay, Andrew Tate. Had these stickers that we could redeem rewards for, so I get to thinking, how much candy can I get for this? So I became a suck-up to all the teachers for a few weeks and get a dozen of stickers. I start loaning them out to random kids with a tax of 50%. So after a few more weeks, people start selling me things for stickers, and that becomes a thing as well. Then there starts to be a black market of sorts, where people don't have to give me profit for stickers. I did the only logical thing. I bought out the market, but didn't tell anyone for more profit. So I start a few fake other markets that make people think they are not giving me stickers. When a few people find out, I blacklist them from every market. No adult ever learned I ate well that year. Good God. Alpha male. Sigma male. Actual MLM behavior. You had a monopoly on the school sticker market. You could legit, like, blackball people from the industry. You would be an incredible CEO. skipping that. When I was 13, I found this thick wallet placed near my room, and my dumbass took it and hid it without thinking. After a few hours, my aunt was freaking out because their wallet's gone and has almost all their money in it. Thanks to my poor memory, I forgot about it and where I placed it until she mentions the color of the wallet. That's when I started thinking, did I take the wallet? And the sudden realization hits me, so I wait a few minutes and act like I'm trying to find it so it wouldn't be sus and eventually return it to her. She thought it was her husband's fault it went missing and gave me money because of returning it. Lesson learned, steal shit and give it back when offered money. Yeah, legit, just take something you're not supposed to take, wait until they, like, put out a reward, and then give it back. Don't do that. That's a crime. That's a specific crime, but I forgot the name of it. Don't do that. I was sitting at a table, and they all started playing Smash or Pass, and I got uncomfy. Went to another friend's table and told her what's happening. She says, oh, go say C? That's not her name. And I was like, sure. And well, I did, and some kid comes over and yelled Pass in C's face, and she got mad and yelled at him a bit. But then I noticed another kid was filming this go down, so I ran up to that kid. That kid said that they only got the floor. Only got the floor, and it doesn't matter that he filmed me and C without our consent. And I went back and told C, threatened them, and then walked away. I went home and told all this to my mom. My mom got the kid who filmed me suspended. Boring. Shitty, but boring. When I was 12, I was at my aunt's house helping her babysit her kid. Get a friend's daughter over as well. She's 14. There was only one guest room. Two of us had to share a bit. See, this is the problem. Everybody has stories like this. Like, certain things that you should never, ever tell anybody else. Like, that you, like, did as a dumbass little kid. Like, you should never, ever have an outlet for this. You should keep those stories to yourself, stew, and become emotionally unchecked and volatile. God! Oh, God. I ended up masturbating in the bed with her right next to me, and I have no idea if she was actually asleep or not. Another time, around that age, on a road trip to the US, I ended up doing that again twice in the car with the rest of the family. I was in the very back and hiding under a blanket. Nobody ever said anything. And I feel like my mom definitely would have if she knew, so I think I got away with it. I should mention I'm biologically female, but I use they, them, so it made it pretty easy to hide. Oh yeah, if you're a dude doing this, like, there's like evidence and shit, even if you keep it in your pants. Like, there's like a cream spot, like, no shot. My memory is vague on how it happened, but I remember I was either 5 or 6, and my sister, who I'm going to call Ella, challenged me on who could jump on our TV the most? After like 3 and 4 tries, and it was my turn, I jumped on our TV, and the TV fell on my leg. After that, I had to go to the hospital and get a cast. A few months when the cast got removed, I got back home, I kicked, then beat up Ella, because when I had the cast, she would always make fun of me. This is why she hates me. She never realized that the reason I did that was because she proposed the idea with the TV in the first place. Now, whenever she asks to do something with me, which is rare, I always decline. Good God. Jump on the TV. Like, what made you want to do that as a jumping block thing? Like, what brought up this idea? I am actually a ghost and died 20 years ago. Whatever. The first time I had sex, we were both high, but I was starting to sober up. Boyfriend at the time, on the other hand, was tripping badly. He was in the middle of going down on me when he came up all sweaty and dizzy and was like, I think I'm about to throw up. So we both laid naked and he started hallucinating and describing to me the weird shit that he was seeing, like floating insects that looked like bubbles. He also said my face looked like I had a funny Snapchat filter on, and he had no perception of time, so if I stopped talking for 5 seconds, he thought I hadn't talked for hours, and he thought I was dead. It was a weird way to lose my virginity, but I still remember it and laugh. I mean, as long as it's not a particularly bad memory for either of you. I watch a friend suck the guts out of a huge tadpole with a syringe in middle school. He's trying to pull the shit out, but ended up pulling organs out as well. It wasn't even his syringe. It belonged to a different friend. She had a minor breakdown over it. Why did you guys own syringes? I thought this was like some science lab shit. Why do multiple of your friends have syringes? That same year, I also cut open a squirrel with another friend that we found on the side of the road. I used a pocket knife and covered my hands with dog shit bags and just poked around inside it. We were trying to figure out why it had died and came to the conclusion it was poison. How? How could you possibly know that? What background do you have to credibly do autopsies? We then threw it away in my friend's outdoor trash can. He wanted to freeze it, but understandably his parents were upset and didn't allow it. Do you guys know that person on TikTok who, like, jokingly he'll sit in his car, he's like, saying everything that I could get canceled over so I don't get canceled for it, and it just gets progressively worse? And he's like, in second grade, I falsely accused my teacher of molesting me. And it just, like, gets worse and worse. He's like, I instigated several war crimes in southern Bolivia. Like, dude, you guys are that dude, but for real. You are that dude, but for real. please don't hurt animals. I mean, this squirrel was already dead in this state, in this case, to be fair. Squirrel autopsy. Oh, good God. Should be no surprise considering I'm in your chat. Yeah, apparently, unfortunately. As a walking teratophiliac who is a thing for Bara-esque facelet. If somebody gives 5 subs, I'll read it. If somebody gives me 5 subs, I'll finish reading this. This is gonna be about you, you know it. I do, that's why I need money to continue. That's why. Oh, God. Why are you guys like this? I don't know. Yet. God damn it. I'm looking up what teratophiliac is. Teratophilia refers to the sexual attraction to either monsters or deformed people. See, the monsters I get. Okay, someone gifted it. God damn it. Two separate people fucking did it. Two separate people did it. Thanks for the 5 gift subs, Modern Crusader and the other guy. Sorry, I missed your name. This music is really appropriate, by the way. Like, it's swelling. It's swelling. It's so unnerving. Fittingly. Okay. As a walking teratophiliac who has a thing for Bara or Bara-esque faceless / object head men, the amount of down thing, bad things I've seen written are absolutely out there. Long story short, I've written 3 vent porn scenes, and the poor straight boys I used to share school with asked to read them. I put one in genuine therapy, and the other is now working for a practicing Catholic bishop. For the longest few weeks of my life, I was an unhealthy amount of obsessed with you. Borderline manic, because I was down bad for the Kwite on the screen. Anyways, I love your vid streamer, slowly becoming comfort streamer. Pet smoke for us. How is that how you end... Thanks for watching the content, I guess. Thanks for watching the vid. God, I'm done. I'm done. I'm moving on. I'm not even gonna comment on that. This is probably gonna sound sad and pathetic, but I'm gay and trans, and I'm growing up in an extremely homophobic and transphobic family. See, that is sad because I'm sorry you're in that predicament, but it's not pathetic. It's just kind of shitty, you know? I don't know anyone like myself, and I'm lonely. I've tried to commit at least 5... I'm sorry, I can't do trauma dumping, but I hope you're doing better. It's like... It's... You know, there's certain things appropriate for the confessions and not. When I was like 4th or 3rd grade, I had a girlfriend and wanted to give her a ring as a gift. So I went in my mom's room while she was sleeping and grabbed the closest rings I saw. Little did I know they were my parents' wedding rings. So the next day I gave my dad's ring to her, and luckily a teacher saw us and she figured it was the wedding ring since my parents' names were carved on them. Oh, God. She called my mom, but I saved my mom's ring and I didn't know it was also a wedding ring, so I threw it in the sewers, never to be found again. Oh, my God. You dumbass. You idiot. You idiot! You fucking moron! I almost drowned my brother when he's a baby. We went swimming and he had a baby float vest on, so I thought he'd be safe in the water on his own, and I put him in the water and swam off. And a minute later, I swam back and the floaters were working, but only for his legs! So his head and upper body were underwater, and because he is autistic, he didn't know he's supposed to set himself upright. He is fine now and loves to swim, but he hates getting his hair wet, and I'm terrified to go swimming with my older brother, who is even more autistic than the first one. I feel like I'm the worst sister alive. I'm just for this, but for other things too. It's not even it's just the imagery of like a child like floating in the water from like by their legs. Like you just see their feet sticking up and they're just bobbing along casually. Yeah, that's right. Why would you have leg floaters? I've never seen leg floaters be a thing. Unless you also have them on your shoulders or some shit. Sometimes I wish I was born as a plant just to see what it's like. Do they think? Do they feel? How conscious are they or their surroundings? It's immoral to pick flowers if they have thoughts and feelings after all. If I hug a tree, does it get happy? Does it know I'm showing it love? Do plants know what love is? Do I know what love is? No, you don't. If a study shows that plants are sentient beings, will vegans starve? I'm gonna break some bad news to you, but there are studies that show that plants in some way can feel pain and communicate danger to other plants around them. It's a very baseline feeling, but apparently There's something we know. One time when I was a lot younger, about 9 or 8, me and my twin were at my mom's house playing games and chilling. Then my brother farts and shits himself, diarrhea, and has to answer and get and has to shower and get taken to the bathroom to clean up his shitty ass. Shitty ass. And then my mom comes back and she's like, "Don't fart." And I'm like, "Okay." The next second I have to fart and I'm contemplating doing it, but ended up just doing it and I shit myself. But this isn't even the worst part. When I was shitting in the toilet, I got my diarrhea on a roommate's carpet that was under the toilet and I left it there. My diarrhea on a random person's carpet. Anyways, why did she say don't fart as if she knew that she was also going to shit her pants? Did their mom give them some food poisoning? And she's like, whatever you do, keep it in. Keep it in. Don't you even think about it. One time when I was 12, I think, I answered an unlisted number on my mom's phone. And there was a woman on the other side begging me to help because her house was flooding. I told her she had the wrong number and I couldn't really do anything to help. I was 11 and to call 911 would have went to my mom, but she was working and asked me to not disturb her for a little. Again, I was 10, didn't know what to do. I said sorry that I couldn't help and to call 911 and she hung up. Out of the shock and confusion, I started feeling real guilty. Tried to call her. She didn't answer. Still think about it some days. Hope she's okay. I gotta be honest, it was definitely an accident, but like that's negligence on the mom's part. Like I didn't know that 911 went to people's like personal phones. I didn't know that. I is that actually a thing? She's probably dead. I mean, if she got on with another operator, I hope not. But rip to the lady. Do 911 calls for operators of 911 actually go to their personal phones? Because that doesn't seem right. I always thought 911 was operated from, like, a dedicated call center. Could she have typed a wrong number? I mean, if she typed 911, there's only, like, there's only so many things you could, like, type in for that. Don't call random numbers for help. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what the deal with that is. I don't know how true that is. But if, like, that is, like, a true story, mom's fault. They don't go to personal phones. It could have been a 911 specific phone. I don't know. I named myself after an Italia character when I was 4. My mom makes lunch for me when I don't have time to do it myself. I'm in uni, and sometimes there's no time. About a year ago, she made a weird dish, seemed nice, but it's a very weird combo of other recipes. However, that day I had a lot of things to do, and I didn't have the appetite nor time to eat it. When I got home, she was really excited to know if I liked it, so I told her it was delicious. No idea how true it was. To this day, the lunchbox is hidden around my bed, and I'm scared to move it or see it. I sometimes think I've accidentally created a modern day's Pandora's box. You're recreating the primordial soup, dude. You're about to, like, recreate the conditions that life was first conceived under. You're about to, like, recreate the first ever single cell organism becoming alive. When I was little, this takes place when I was 4, my dad would cover his pee-pee all the time and wouldn't let me or my younger sister see it. I'd hope. I didn't really understand why, then, as they never told me. And then trying so hard to hide all the time made me really curious. So I had make it my mission to catch a glimpse. I remember it succeeding and telling my mom and she laughed. I don't remember what it looks like and I'd like not to. Now that I'm older, I realize they did that because I'm a girl and seeing guy parts is weird, especially your father's at a young age. That is really innocent. That is really innocent. That is like a really innocent, like, dumbass kid thing to do. But fuck me, dude. Did not make it comfortable to read. I was that kind of edgy, mentally ill middle schooler who thought it was cool to plan how to run away and murder people. I thought it was so badass, I also role-played as creepypasta characters with my friends who thought it was cool to try to run away to murder people. I also thought it was cool to be a psychopath and tried to fake the test results when I got examined for mental issues. Instead, I was just diagnosed with ADHD and depression. Bro, you tried to get the fucking cool disease and you're like, man, no, I'm just sad and like neurodivergent. Oh, you got a fucking, dude, you got shafted so hard. Hell of a reality check. Thankfully, the ADHD means I have a fucked memory and don't have to voluntarily remember shit like this. I don't think I could survive the constant cringe otherwise. God, your 11-year-old you had a rude awakening. It's like, you're not a psychopath. You're just like depressed. When I was in year 3, second grade, my friend group had a civil war. During the main war, things got hella brutal. Imagine 27-year-old kids brawling around a big tree. With my growth spurt dodging ash, trying not to get squashed during the fight. The fat kid swung off a tree and drop-kicked me, so I kind of just ran away and hid in a bush. The fight escalated and some kids started hurling rocks, as kids do, and my best friend got hit square in the head. Fuck, I think he got a concussion. The whole thing ended when a girl snitched and the teacher came. Nobody liked that girl afterwards. I mean, it was good for you, man, because you ran away. You ran away and hid. She saved your ass. You owe her. You don't get to be mad when you fucking ran away. Basically, listen, trying to murder a fellow preschooler or elementary schooler is not new. Basically, I stabbed a kindergartner. I know it sounds bad, but in defense, it was also a kindergartner, and at the time, and it was very stupid. And it was with a relatively blunt pencil and barely pierced the skin. I'm kind of making it sound worse than it actually was, but I got into a play fight with some kid. Pencils got involved, and I suggested we try to stab each other. But it's not my fault I was faster than him. Jokes aside, though, I kind of felt like shit about for a while, even though there weren't any huge repercussions for it. Damn. You got away with the crime. I'm 19 going on 20, used to live with my grandparents. My grandma is super controlling. She won't let me have any of my electronics in my room. I'm only allowed to have my phone, Switch, and 3DS. All my electronics were to stay inside her room at night. I got in trouble for bringing my phone to work twice, and she tried to ground me. And she's doing this when you're 19, 20? That's fucking weird. I don't know, like, some people who, like, get that controlling at that age, like, I don't know. That shit's weird to me. Oops. Oh, now I gotta fucking scroll all the way back down. Give me a second. God fucking damn it. Ugh. And I can't just fucking drag it. Oh my god, I'm gonna cry. It was a misinput! It was a misinput! Fucking Christ, there's not a faster way to do this. The lunchbox is still hidden. Okay, we're... Where is it? Okay, I found it. Okay, we're good to go. Stabbed a kindergartner. Going 20. After nearly 13 years of being gaslighted into submission, I stood up for myself and left. Now I'm stuck living at my friend's house. Am I the asshole? I mean, she did stop me when I was stuck in foster care. Did I do the right thing? I mean, you're an adult now, man. If you felt that's not a situation you want to be in, you can make decisions for yourself. Like, fair. Like that. Like, even if you liked your grandma and she wasn't an asshole, you have full right to leave when you want. You're an adult. If you want to make that decision for yourself, that is yours to make. You're not the asshole for moving out. That's, like, totally your choice. I have a golden doodle, and she's blonde. Not only that, she's a dumb blonde. Whenever the bathroom doors open, she will jump into the tub. When I try to put a leash on to take her out, she'll flop on the floor. This dog is so dumb, I have to laugh. I laugh at this poor dog struggling at life, struggling to remember the tricks we taught her just to get a small treat. Her and her small bean of a brain can't comprehend how to not climb on the couch. This is just how every pet owner feels. When I was 5, I'd eaten a cupcake with the wrapper, and I almost killed my pet pig because he tried to kill my dog that I have had since I was 4. Also, when my dad's mom, if you call her my grandmother, I'll threaten you like you threaten us, would visit us, she would always smack my... Never mind, I understand. Your dad's mom... My apologies. I'm sorry that you have a good reason to not want any association with her. My mistake. I'm sorry. She would always do inappropriate things. She spiked my drinks! And now I can't have anyone fix me a drink or come up to me from behind without me getting a PTSD attack. That's totally valid. Again, I'm really sorry. Ugh. When I was younger, I think like 5 to 6, I was a book nerd, like hardcore read the Warrior Cat books and more. So when you were either a Guardians of Gahul kid or a Warrior Cats kid. I was a Guardians of Gahul kid. So went to book fair, came all along, I tried to scrounge up as much money as possible. Well, my school had the thing where we went door to door selling cookie dough. I got the bright idea to act like I was selling cookie dough to get money for books, and I did. I made $120, I think, which is a lot for a kid. It is, good stacking that paper. I ended up using like half of it, then I hide the rest in my closet to use later. We ended up moving not long after, so I never had to answer for my crimes. I don't know. I think that's fair. Just, you're a hustler. Andrew Tate, Sigma Grind Set. I burned my bed in an experiment with a Cheetos bag. I was at first... Oh, the fucking playlist ended. Damn it. I was at first using fire to melt small wax squares that gave off nice smells when I... But I got bored. So I ate a snack-sized Cheetos bag. I wanted to see if it was flammable. My dumbass thought to do the experiment in my room. On my bed. I even went to the bathroom to get toilet paper as a Kindle. I lit the match, set down the matchbox, picked up the bag, and dropped the match in. My parents were not happy with me. They were mad, they weren't mad, just disappointed, and thought they raised an idiot that starts fire away from water sources. Y'all should have seen some of my earlier videos. I was making, like, very dangerous. I was making, like, aerosol can flamethrowers for the sake of doing a bit. Very stupid. I'm Aerospec, and I've only had a crush on a dating sim. Anyone is on a dating sim character? I don't know. When I was 7, I put my mom's nail polish on my siblings' eyelids like eyeshadow while they were sleeping. When they woke up, either they couldn't open their eyes or some of the nail polish got in their eyes, but they started crying. My dad came to the room when he heard and then washed off the nail polish. Afterwards, my dad asked me if I was the one who did it, and I didn't want to get in trouble, so I blamed it on my little sister, which caused her to be put in timeout in the basement for half an hour. Why are parents so goddamn trusting of the first person they ask? You did what with aerosol? Or it was like Febreze. It was Febreze. I made like a Febreze flamethrower. This is incredibly dangerous, and you should not do this. If it goes wrong, like if the flame catch... Basically, what I did was I had like a Febreze can, and I put a lighter in front of it, and I just like lit the lighter and just fucking pulled the trigger on the Febreze, and it made a flamethrower. But here's the thing. If the flame goes into the bottle, it can potentially fucking blow up and like send shrapnel everywhere. So, full stop, they said basement? Yeah. I made out with a bitch. You're the stereotype of every VTube viewer on Earth, dude. I literally fell in love with a VTuber model. I don't care if this isn't a sin. It feels off to keep it to myself. No, this is so... Batman could be breaking every single one of my fingers, and he would not get this out of me. The fact that I fell in love with it was some weird Shiba thingy. Just makes me feel off. God. I had a mental breakdown in 7th grade instead of cooling off. Like, what's the fun in that? I don't want to go to jail, and you're... I think I'm on a watch list or something, but ever since it happened, I haven't been stopped by the police, so it's fine. Moving on. I legit can't sleep without my cats in my room. That's really cute, actually. That's, like, really sweet. One's name is Mama, and we kept 2/3 of the cats she birthed. I need at least Mama and one of her kittens to feel safe enough to sleep. I mean, but it is, like, endearing. It sucks that it's, like, you can't get to bed without it, but it's, like... Cats are cute. I like sleeping with my cat in the bed, or in the room, or just in the room over. But without them both, I won't sleep, and if it's just one, I will struggle to sleep. Okay, so when I was, like, 6 or 7, my cousin had rabbits, and we both were really dumb. You motherfuckers and rabbits. You motherfuckers and rabbits. She is the same age as me, and when we were younger, we wanted to be YouTubers really bad, as every 6-year-old does. So we recorded ourselves doing anything. Long story short, she told me to play superheroes with the rabbits. She told me to hold them by their hind legs and spin them, then let them go that they would fly, and I did? And she yelled at me and told on me to her mom, who hit me and said I was crazy? That's the other dumbass's kid fault. It should have explained it better. When my grandma was in the hospital, we went to visit a few times. Second time I ever went, they didn't let me in, even though they had the first time. So I asked my mom to stay with me in the lobby. But she wanted my Nana to stay with me so she could say goodbye to my grandpa. But I didn't want to stay with my Nana because she kind of scared me since she slapped me once due to a fight, and I bit her arm after she did. So I begged my mom to stay instead. My grandpa died a few days later, and I still feel guilty about it, not letting my mom. You know, I don't think that's on you. It sucks that, like, Your mom couldn't say goodbye to her grandpa, but as far as I'm concerned, a parent's priority is always their child, and she was leaving you with someone that made you feel genuinely unsafe for good reason. So I don't know. No, that was valid. It's tragic, but it's like your mom. I'm glad your mom agreed to stay with you, because that means she had her priorities in the right place. As shitty as it is to choose between those two things, it nothing comes before the child's well-being, in my opinion. Like that doesn't matter. That's out of that. You got a good mom. Don't feel guilty. Just be thankful for her. That's all. When I was 12, one of my friend's confessions to me over text, and I texted my mom telling her about it. We sit there over 30 minutes talking about how to tell her I don't like her, and we decided to have us go to the mall and have her stay the night. I have to say that night was the most regret thing I've ever agreed to. We were talking then, she was talking about her problems and stuff, but the one thing she said to me was, I was going to cuddle you before you wake up, so I set my alarm to wake up at 8 a.m. I guess it just made her uncomfy. We've been at 1K like the whole street. Jeez, you're fucking right. We're still holding? Goddamn, I feel so popular. Guys, I didn't even shout this out on YouTube. We're just like 1K Andying out here. Let's go. Holy fuck. When I was 5, I had a fish tank in my room. It was on top of my dresser. I'd woken up one night really late, like 2 a.m. or so, and I thought it would be a really good idea to feed the fish. So I got the food, but I couldn't reach their tank. So I tried to stack a bunch of stuff on top of each other. This included my giant stuffed dog. I stood on top of it and I just barely reached the top. I spilled all the food into the tank, and out of fear, I pissed all over the stuffed dog. I put it back on her back porch and never told anyone. In middle school, two of my friends and I all like the same guy. It's middle school drama. I've lied about my gender all my life. I hope you figure it out. Me and my friend used to imagine the different characters from fandoms we were interested in were living and hanging out with us. Okay, a lot of kids do that. You want to be friends with the people you see on cartoons, you know? We even imagined them going back and forth between our houses, and we had many games of truth or dare with them. I felt weird doing certain things because of me thinking that they were there and watching what I was doing. Even ended up leaving space on the bed for them so I could cuddle with them off the bed. Well, that's kind of cute. That's kind of cute, like, if you're a toddler. Like, that's endearing. That's endearing. You're a little real-life self-insert. I tried to break my friends up who are dating each other because they're so fucking annoying and are like, oh, you're still single? We could tell. Yeah, fuck them. I hope they break up too. Once when I was in second grade, I had a crush on my friend. I'll call him Jay. So at the time, I had a diary, and I drew me and Jay kissing, and Jay, who was very mean, and his friend stole my diary, saw my drawing, and told the teacher and made fun of me about it, and the teacher yelled at me for it and got upset and threw away the diary, and I got upset and threw away the diary. Jay and his friends kept making fun of me throughout elementary school. Now I can't get a partner and blame that experience for my lack of romantic companions. Damn, tragic backstory. I don't... What does SSG stand for? Because I know SSG is something very different than you. Special service groups? Assaulted me and multiple other people? Fuck. He did it because he was mad. It's dramatized in an old movie, but you should never get physical with someone when you're upset. You're thinking of the KSG. Set seed glitchless? Yeah, I'm sorry that happened to you. That's really shitty. A year and a half ago, I would fuck my friend's girlfriend in secret, but in my defense, her girlfriend was my ex/best friend. No, you're still a piece of shit. BTW, my friend knew that, me and my best friend, that doesn't change shit. That does not change a fucking thing. After a couple of months of sleeping with her girlfriend, I drunkenly convinced my friend to eat me out and promised not to tell their girlfriend. So now a year has passed, I have friends with benefits relationships with both of them, and they still don't know? They're literally... You're all equally shitty. Just fucking go. Just open up. You all fucking did it. You're all like equally evil, dude. Holy fuck. You're all going behind each other's backs, my guy. This is like a fan fiction setup. Oh my god. Oh my god. So this was about 3 years ago, all right? I was 16 and got sent to the mental hospital. And my boyfriend at the time brought me some weed edibles that my mom homemade, so my roommate and I got hella high. And dude, being stoned in the mental hospital was an experience. The staff never found out that we did get in trouble because we were being too loud. We also had a puzzle and we were just staring at it, not knowing what to do. India, if you see this or remember you, I hope you remember the Jaguar puzzle. Edibles in the mental asylum, Doug. When I was a kid, there was this one time I was eating jelly beans, and for some godforsaken reason, I wondered whether or not a jelly bean would fit into my nostril. Ugh. Is it bad that I'm curious now? That I kind of want to find out if it does. And being the stupid kid I was, I shoved the jelly bean up my nose to satisfy my curiosity. I started panicking because I kept pushing it further in when I was trying to like pull it out. No, see, that's where you close the other nostril and you go, you gotta have strong lungs for that. I gotta blow my nose. I have really strong nostrils. Like, this probably sounds like a sneeze to you. This is probably gonna sound like a sneeze, but this is just me using a tissue. God, I have incredibly healthy lungs. But luckily my mom was there and got me to blow my nose so that it would come out. And that's why you should always supervise your kids. How the fuck did that sound like a sneeze? It wasn't a sneeze. It just sounds like you're using a tissue. I've gotten multiple people telling me that it sounds like a sneeze. Maybe I just have a huge inflated ego. Maybe when I was a kid, still am, I was obsessed with music and tried to remember everything my parents played. Well, one day, my parents played was a little known song from my darkest days called Porn Star Dancing. One of my friends at the time was a girl who shared a name with one of the names mentioned in the song. We were talking about future jobs she may want, and I may or may not have suggested she could be a porn star. And you got her in trouble. God fucking damn it. God fucking damn it. Oh, that is hilariously tragic. When I was 9, my dad got a small and flimsy wooden plane for me and my sister. When he left the room, he told us not to touch the plane as it could break. My 9-year-old brain thought, oh, it's wood, it won't break. As soon as I picked it up, it snapped in half. I set two halves down, and as soon as my dad came back, I pointed out my sister and said she did it. I don't remember if I was snickering at all after or if my dad found out, but I know that I still don't care. When I was 6 or something, my cousins would come over to my house and play games with me. One game they really liked to play, for whatever reason, was marriage. The game would always end with me kissing one of my cousins. I never wanted to do it, and I would express that to my other cousins, but they'd pressure me anyways. I gave in because I was young, too young to know that was wrong. This day, I hate myself for it, and I hope they never see their cousins again. You were all kids, but I hope those cousins get what's fucking coming to them. That's still shitty. Still shitty. Doesn't matter. Oh, when I was little, I thought gay people were something made up by the internet. They are. They're not real. All this shit you see on my channel about gay people and gay dating sims, it's fake. It's made up. They're not real. They're boogeymen. They're fake. they don't exist. Don't believe them. Don't believe what the fucking liberal media tries to tell you. Gay people are not real. I then caught my older brother making out with his boyfriend in his bedroom, and I was horrified because it made me believe that my brother was made by the internet, like an AI or something like Miku. So for the next few days, I cried whenever I saw my brother because I thought he wasn't a real person. My mom then later had to explain to me that gay people were a real thing and my brother was gay. That's as far as like innocence to funny ratio, that's probably the highest one so far. It's just some dumbass little kid stuff. Mixed in with, like, you actually being sad. That's so funny. That's gotta be my favorite one, because it's not, like, overall harmful. But it's really funny, dude. Oh. That's my favorite confession of all time so far. It didn't make me hurt. Me and my brother were messing around in my dad's room, and I found a balloon-looking thing in a wrapper. I grabbed it and went into my room with my brother and proceeded to blow it up like a balloon and toss it away like everything else. Then my dad came in later and asked if I seen something that looked like a balloon, and I said no. I didn't know it was a condom until 4 years later. God damn it. Same person as the magazine hiding thing? If you read that one, Jesus. I broke my left big toe and didn't tell anyone because my mom was already mad at me for being too gay. It healed, but it looks pretty deformed. You can see where the fracture was caused. It's leaning to the side in a way, and it's a purplish-blue color around the base. I'm too scared to go to the doctor because I don't want to explain why both of my legs are covered in the phrase, I don't read Homestuck over and over again in different colored ink. I lost a bet. I mean, no, I think that's an incredibly based thing to have on your skin, because Homestuck isn't real either. I think it's good that you let people know that anybody trying to tell you Homestuck exists is a liar, a propagandist, and a historical revisionist. It doesn't exist. Yo, Whis, thank you for the raid, man. Hope you had a good stream. For those just joining us, we're reading some of my chat's confessions, and I'm gonna be honest, they are usually god-awful. We have had, some fucking horrendous prison-worthy shit in here. If you guys have done confessions, I'm sure you've been around the ringer as well. People went anonymous will admit to lots of things. But, he, just brace yourselves if you plan on sticking around. Hope you had a good stream, Whist. I went through a phase where I thought music would solve all my problems and wrote a cover of Counting Stars, trying to convince my parents to let me get a hamster. I would practice it in the bathroom downstairs, completely oblivious to the fact that the sound echoes and can be heard through most of our downstairs, so even though I never actually performed it for my parents, they most definitely knew. I did end up getting the hamster though, so who's the winner? I really wanted to be a cat when I was in sixth grade. You fucking furry. I'm not even a furry. Yes, you are. You're a furry. Anyways, I was playing soccer during recess and I got super mad at a kid. He said, "Aw, is the little baby mad?" And I said, "No, but the kitty is." And I scratched their chest. I'm not finishing that. When we were kids, me and my sister were playing outside while Dad was watching us. He decided to leave for now to do whatever, leaving us alone. Soon, my sister wanted to go to the bathroom, but there was no bathroom. And I saw her look at a bottle of Gatorade my dad left behind. Without a second thought, she opened the bottle and peed in it. Let's just say that Dad no longer likes Gatorade. He still doesn't know what happened to this day. Just left it out sitting too long. And guys, it all comes back around to the piss bottle thing. If you think your pee, a single peeing session, will fit in a water bottle, it won't. It will overflow and you will get it on your fingers and your fingers will be sticky and smell. I'm telling you this from experience. One time I was taking my dog out in my old crappy apartment building and there was this odd button panel in the entrance hallway. I was younger and stupid and decided to randomly press the buttons on this important-looking panel. Basically, I set off the fire alarm and firefighters came. I got blamed. It got blamed on some bag catching on the handle that would typically set off the alarm. Okay, not too bad. When I was younger, I was so gullible my older brother convinced me gum tasted better and longer if I ate it with the wrapper still on. You idiot. Specifically, Trident gum. I believed him so much, it took me 5 years to realize it was a lie, and it was just to make fun of me. How I realized? He was so confused as to what I was doing, and I was tired of picking out paper from gum. I now have trust issues. A really long time ago, when I was about 10, I was staying at my cousin's house. I was a nosy-ass kid, and I was left alone, don't lie, and being the little cunt I was, I went snooping in my uncle's room. I think I was looking for candy and looking in the drawers, and I found a really long candy dildo. Along with a few other things. That was the day I got yelled at for eating half a dildo and the day I found out my uncle was a bottom. Awesome. Awesome. When I was younger, I had a dream I had stabbed my sister and for weeks I wasn't able to look at her because I felt extremely guilty. One day my mom was taking me to school. She told me to say bye to my sister, which caused me to cry on the spot, sobbing. She asked me what's wrong and I didn't respond. Still feel the guilt even though this was from when I was 8 or something. When I was in first grade, I was bored during reading time, and there was a rock that was in my shoe. I got the rock out and had the bright idea. Hey, I wonder what would happen if I put this in my ear. Long story short, and I told my mom that my ear hurt. We went to the hospital, and they had to blast water and suction it out of my ear. I know the doctors gave my mom the rock, and I think she still has it to this day. It's like keeping a baby tooth. One time, my mom and I were having a big fight. The next day, she asked me to make her a smoothie while she gets ready for work. I was still pissed, so I add extra matcha, kind of like green tea. It gives you energy and shit because my mom can't have coffee, which can make your stomach feel like shit if you have too much. She called me later. I pretended I didn't know and it was an accident, and we were both laughing about it. You evil motherfucker. I feel so bad now, but when we were younger, I made my brother believe that bees were drawn to earwax, and if he didn't clean his ears, a bee would get in his ear and lay eggs there. He started excessively cleaning his ears to the point where one of his ears got infected, and when he told my parents why he was doing it, they got really mad at me. We laugh about it now, but I still don't know what compelled me to make up that story. To be fair, there are some, parents who will make up stories like that, too. And they can have equally as bad consequences. You absolutely should clean your ears. Not using Q-tips, like actually like cleaning your ears just for maintenance sake.
But God.
I have kept the secret, but I identify as... I hope you figure it out. I shot a kid's wheelchair wheel with a BB gun when I was 12 because he took my airsoft gun and broke it. No, I'm not finishing this. Guys, you expect me to, like, you see this part. Like, it was one thing, like, when, it, like, doing the action when you're 12, and then it's another referring to him as this in the modern day. Listen, guys, the scrolling past the trans stuff isn't, like, me trying to not talk about, like, the issues. It's just, it's heavy shit, and heavy in a way that's serious, as opposed to a way that I can, like, jibe off of, that I could, you know, bounce off of. And I'd rather not do that to somebody's, like, lived in, like, really hard experiences. Anyways, he was really mean, and every time he came over to my house, he'd break one of my things, and his mom didn't do anything about it because he was in a wheelchair. The last thing he ever did was fall out that wheelchair and not get up. Anyways, we had to move on after that. One time I was texting in class, and I was trying to type the word bigger, but I have fat-ass fingers and... motherfucker! I had a severe panic attack as I typed it out and I was hyperventilating. My cousin is black and he gets called it all the time, so I accidentally typed it down. I felt so bad and just broke down. At least, I mean, it's good. Good moral compass. Strong moral compass because you felt bad. I hurled a lamp at my friend. It smashed into his head and gave him permanent head trauma, and he lost feeling in his neck permanently. He lost all memory of the incident, and he thinks that I was the one who saved him by calling an ambulance. It haunts me to this day, knowing that a small action rippled and changed my friend's life forever. This last part is true. One time when I was a child, I had heard about how people would break their legs in prairie dog holes on TV, but for some reason I didn't believe it, so I dug a hole about a foot deep where my family had set up our basketball hoop and covered it with leaves, and when my dad went to go play basketball with my brother, he fell in and broke his leg. You idiot. Oh my. Like, kids are stupid. And that's usually to their own detriment. In these confessions, we get a whole lot of kids are stupid in a way that fucking destroys. Like, we get a whole lot of, like, kids are stupid in a way that hurts everyone around them. God. One time, my family was eating Chinese food, and my sister was eating pork fried rice and spit it out because it tasted funny. She gave it to her mom, and she was eating it. My sister looked at me and said, "I told mom it was duck sauce," and she ate it. Wait. My sister was eating pork fried rice and spit it out, so she gave it to her mom. She was eating it. My sister looked at me and said, "I told mom it was a duck sauce." She ate it. As a snitch, so I told my mom that my sister is shit on for it, like, daily. My mom said she got her back. Now, that scares me, so I don't fuck with food. I don't understand how you fucked with it. This isn't really coherent. 7,500 hours in Sims 4. Owned most game packs. Got bored of Sims 4. Went to Sims 3. Never got bored of it. This is a... Okay, whatever. You're addicted to a game. Get in line. When I was 7, I was playing a game with a few friends in a pool that consisted of pulling each other's hair slash body parts. When everyone was turning away from me, I attempted to drown the person that I hated most. He had long hair and nobody noticed, and he passed out from, you know, me trying to kill him. Nobody knows what happens except me. He was in the hospital for like 4 days. Attempted murder is not new in these confessions, but this is the closest I think anybody's gotten. When I was in middle school, I went to my first convention, and there was a FNAF cosplay fan panel. The characters were taking dares, and my dumbass 12-year-old brain tried to dare Toy Bonnie to kiss Purple Guy? Toy Bonnie was around my age, and Purple Guy wasn't. Wait, I'm so confused. FNAF cosplay panel. I missed that part. Like, I read it, but it like, just went over my head. Obviously, they refused, and I was left. Toy Bonnie's around my age, and Purple Guy wasn't. Obviously, they refused, and I left in total shame when I realized how creepy and gross that was, and I cringe whenever I think about it. Yeah, a little bit. My mom said that if anything went up my ass, I would die, and I tried it. I was 15, and I used my mom's toothbrush because I had an electric one. After I did, I was happy I didn't die. I decided it wasn't for me. She said the toothbrush smelled bad, and she let me smell it. I said I didn't smell anything, and she used that toothbrush for the rest of the year! Oh, that's what she gets to lying to you, man. Like, if you put anything up your ass, you will die. I wonder if that's true. Puts thing up my ass? Like, Jesus Christ. That poor one. No, that's on her. That's on her. That's on her for telling the kid he'd die if he tried. He wouldn't have even thought about putting it up his ass if she had just kept her mouth shut. In all my lifetime, I'm 14. Okay, we're about to read someone's body count, and not the sex kind, the military blacklist kind. I'm 14. You're 14 now, and this is like the amount of kills you've got on your ledger. I killed 3 frogs and 5 fish by dumping them in a bathtub. Threw a cat down hardwood floor stairs. This is just not real. I don't believe this is real. If it is, I'm not finishing it. My grandma is nose blind or whatever, so she can't smell. Sometimes she'll drive me around if I need a ride or something. So when I'm in her car sometimes, I will fart if I need to. I make sure that they are not audible, and I make sure that my window is open a good amount. I feel bad about it because she can't smell, so I don't think there is much harm. Man, I'm gonna be honest. I fart around people who can't smell it. I'm gonna fuck. Like, I fart in front of you guys all the time. They're just like insomnia. For real. At work, we replaced our keyboards. The ones we don't use now are the ones that have the pop-out keys, and I was the one who had to put them away in case we needed to use them later. I swapped keys around so one of them says, "Fuck you," classic, I know. This was a year ago, and I put my notice in for next week. No one's found it, so I'm gonna get away with it. Tongue-in-cheek. Little parting gift. I've been unironically eating chalk for as long as I can remember. This is a My Strange Addictions thing, dude. Like, this is something you're doing to this day. I remember at the back of the classroom eating the dirty, nasty, used chalk when no one was looking. I never sat down and thought about how weird it is until now. Sometimes I still eat sidewalk chalk when I'm bored, and it makes all my friends avoid me. Or they might just avoid me because I watch Kwite. You can't say all this shit and then, like, this is a funny meme. Like, I get it. But you can't say all this shit and then try to do that. What a fucking pivot. What a fucking pivot. Susie from Deltarune. I can't believe they made her a real person. When I was in middle school, I made friends with a really annoying girl. They were a horse girl and wouldn't leave me alone for more than 5 minutes, so throughout the school years, I'd deliberately avoid them and go out of my way to not be the same classes. It caused so much drama, and I still feel bad because they claimed I was their only friend. And their fault. I almost lit a barn on fire with my sister inside. When I was 5, she was 3, my grandmother had left a lighter on her back porch, and me and my sister, being idiots, decided to go and light some things. After a while, we decided that it would be cool to see the barn go up in flames, so I shoved her in it and lit the lighter, but before I could, my aunt found me and took it away? Jesus! Back in middle school, or something other than there was in this class, he was very mentally ill and would literally throw anything we could find. We had to evacuate the whole classroom multiple times. It was terrifying and probably caused a small bit of my PTSD. Oh, also, I almost ran over my boyfriend with a golf cart. God. I almost killed someone, allegedly. So basically what happened was, I'm wondering what will happen if I stab someone with a knife. I was a 6-year-old, edgy. I had to plan to wait until my older sister was asleep and poke her with a knife when I was done and blame it on my brother. Good thing I was too lazy. Good God. I thought you weren't doing confessions tonight? I don't think I said that anywhere. I said I wasn't going to be able to get through all of them tonight. Because, like, look how long we've been going, and look, we're not even halfway through yet. One time when I was 5, I found an almost empty Powerade, so little me put soap, bubble solution, paper towels, water, and watercolor, then I put it back in the Powerade box, then a day later my brother drank it. He called my mom. Me and my mom were in the car when this happened, so she asked if I did it. I said no. He still doesn't know I did it to this day. Your mom absolutely fucking knows you did it. You are one of them knows one of them did it. Like, there's absolutely no way they don't. When I was in daycare, I used to get into little fights with some kid over a plushie of Poe from Kung Fu Panda. And one day I got tired of it and I threw it through the fence door onto the street and told him to go get it. And I shut the gate and went back inside. Turns out they got hit by a car while trying to get back inside. Not gonna lie, I still don't regret it.
Huh.
One time when I was in middle school, I overheard my mom catching my brother jack off, which wouldn't have been so bad except for the fact that they were sharing a bed at the time because I think one of the bedrooms were being remodeled. But I overheard that my brother was jacking off while he was in the same bed as my mom, and I've never told anyone about it. And of course, we're the first ones that gotta hear about it. Of course we are. Finish your drinks, guys. Finish your drinks. Oh my fucking god. Oh my fucking god. One time when I was a kid, it was Christmas morning. I woke up before anyone else in the house. We loved those mini sugar cookies with the colorful sprinkles on them that came in the box. Mom had filled up bowls of them for each of them. Long story short, I stole all three of my brother's cookies and they didn't notice because they were stupid babies at the time. Stupid idiot babies. Guys, I'm gonna be honest. I need more. It's been an hour since the last ad break. You guys can deal with one more, right? Right? You're gonna have to, because you're gonna have to. Violin is very fitting. Fart and or shit incoming. Just farted. You got three ads? I mean, it's all gonna total up to 60 seconds nonetheless. Like, it doesn't matter how many ads you get, it's gonna be 60 seconds in total. You came back too fast. But yeah, I didn't take a pee break, I just got a drink. Sometimes I would imagine me killing my friends and random people I know when I chase them, or just whenever, and then after I get this weird feeling where I'm strangely happy, almost like a euphoria type thing, and I usually want to go and hurt someone, but I force myself not to, and I'm worried that one day I'm gonna hurt someone or myself or even kill them. Yeah, like, talk to a therapist. This is something you can get help for if you're, like, in genuine fear of hurting others. Like, you can talk to someone before it happens. Like, it's... You're not alone. Like, you can't... Like, if... there's resources. When I was 4 to 5, I... Nope. I've been making some easy cash by making fetish content where I eat a lot and then vomit on camera. Making just a small enough amount that I won't be taxed on it. I don't have an eating disorder, and I don't condone this. I just do it for filming purposes. Please judge me lightly. I'm majoring in English, so who knows when I'll next get paid a decent amount. God. OnlyFans. I remember as a kid, I didn't know what sex was, but I wanted to try whatever it was, and Nope. My boyfriend broke up with me through a note that he didn't give me, so I hacked into his Snap account and broke up with who he was cheating on me with. Then again, he did say that he wanted me to be the dream to his George, so it was definitely deserved. That man's a whore. He knows who fucking Dream and George are. He knows what Dream Not Found is. He's been around the block. That motherfucker's been passed around. Guarantee. There's no fucking way he knows what that is on his own time. There's no fucking way. God. He's been with another woman who knows what that is. In first/second grade, I really wanted to know what chalk tasted like, but couldn't find. It's just another chalk eater, ain't it? I had a dream about Moist Critical giving me a chainsaw that I used to stab my dog with. I thought he was a bear. When I had come to the realization that I was stabbing my dog, he glared at me very disappointed and walked away. Why do you guys give dreams like it's a confession? Like it didn't happen. It's not real. Your mind made it up. I have stolen a collective total of around $1,000 from Walmart and Target over the past few years. Nothing big, but just a bunch of very little stuff. very often. College student, so it's mostly just snacks, toothpaste. The biggest theft was probably about $50 in one go. But is it really stealing if the CEO makes that much money in like 60 seconds? I'm not saying I condone it. I'm just not saying anything about it in general. Like, I didn't see this. I didn't read that. Condone what? I didn't see anything. When I was in the third grade, I stole my cat, my at the time best friend's favorite stuffed animal because I thought it was cute. Soon found out she'd had it since it was a baby. I felt horrible. And I ended up losing it during a move, and it haunts me. And not really, because she also called me fat as a child and told me to get in shape. So screw you, Abby. Some of y'all, like, use these as your outlets. Like, this is, you legit treat me as therapy. Like, you say the, like, most, the thoughts you've wanted to say to these people for ages. In the confession. It's unbelievable. Every time someone was rude to me, elementary through middle school, I'd take something from one person, sometimes up to three, and put it in the rude person's backpack. I'd wait a certain amount of time and see if they were persistently a jerk, then I'd do it again. Being quiet, I was well-trusted and never had an eye kept on me, so I was never caught. I ate a rock once. Don't regret it. It was small and tasty. I'd eat a fucking rock again. I've eaten many things that shouldn't be eaten. I will list them now. Shampoo, conditioner, the aforementioned rock rubber bands, a bead soap, lots of soap, ice sand. Woo baby love sand if you haven't picked it up yet. I have an eating disorder called Pika? Yeah, woo? Rock eater? Rock eater disorder? I don't know. When I was four, my sister and I headed a bush and pooped in it. My sister left when I stayed. I got a piece of plastic in my sister's poop. I think you know the rest. I started playing with the poop. I also ran over someone's dog with my tricycle. God. Okay, so I haven't really done terrible things in my life. The only thing I can really say I've done is underage drinking. What? What? Who underage drinks? I'd never drink underage. Every time I've drank it under the age of 21, it was either in Australia or England. That's the, like, I would never break the law. You guys know that. You guys know I wouldn't. You guys know that. I'm a law-abiding citizen. Who would do that? Not me. Back in elementary school, a friend of mine brought a knife to, isn't Pika pronounced Pika? No idea. A friend of mine brought a knife to school on two separate occasions, wanting to kill two different people. The only reason she didn't was because the first time she dropped it and one of the third graders saw it, the second time the person she wanted to stab and wasn't at school, and she decided it was too much work. It's weird that the number one, like, most preventative thing towards murder is laziness on the murderer's part, on the would-be murderer's part. Quite, I know for a fact you're banned from 6 different Canadian provinces. You don't know shit. Even if you did, you're supposed to keep it to yourself, Wallace. Isn't that true? Isn't that right? I thought we had a deal. Long story short, when I was like 5, I stole a leopard print door handle because I forgot to ask my parents to buy it. The only way they found out was because of my dumbass brothers wanting to see what I was holding so gently in my tiny little baby hands. They took it back to the store. One time in 2020, my granddad gave me his credit card to sign up for Spotify, but I ended up keeping the info and bought a signed K-pop album without his knowledge. He saw the purchase and thought it was Spotify stealing from him. The album sits on my shelf and I still haven't told him I bought something. One time in first grade, pushed a girl off the monkey bars and she broke her arm. The worst part is I wanted to hurt her and called her the meanest word I knew, which was lesbian. Don't worry, dear viewer, I'm indeed very gay and trans now. Talk about projecting, am I right? It's how I always go. Every gay person was homophobic when they're young, and when they find out they're gay, they continue to be homophobic, but, like, ironically this time. Not every gay person. I've just seen it more happen more than once. When I was 7, I was sleeping in my parents' bed. I thought I was asleep. On the contrary, I was couldn't sleep and very awake. They started going at it? While you were... That's... Oh my fucking god. That's the worst version of that, like, earlier one where the kid at the sleepover heard it. Why?
Oh my god.
What fucking parents do that? Why? What fucking parents do that? Oh my... Why... Oh my god.
Back in fifth grade, a friend of mine was taking shit from some guy, L, and he kind of went off on the guy. Things escalated, and I ended up breaking the guy's nose. He got ratioed. Twitter terms. As a little child, I stole a shit ton of money from my parents through Roblox. Oh, you were one of those microtransactions kids. Like, your parents naively hooked up their credit card to your account, and you just ran that bank account up. I asked my mom about buying some on Roblox, and she's cool with it. However, my tiny brain thought, oh, then I can buy stuff when I want. And over a couple of months, I kept buying stuff and got my ass beat for it when they found out. One time when I was younger, my best friend had an enemy. I don't recall this ordeal at all, but she had told me an entire plan she had to get back at the person for something they had done. And I was like, yeah, okay, I understand. Don't worry, I won't tell anyone. Then immediately told the person. I was a sucky friend. Spent an hour drawing you. No torso, just hoodie floating with... Okay, yeah. When I was six, I cut off my hair and put it in my grandparents' kitchen drawer. 9 years later, I was making mac and cheese at their house. I looked in the same drawer for a ladle spoon, and the hair that I cut off was still there, and I was like, wow, that's really cool, and closed the drawer. Does hair, like, decompose? Does hair, like, get nasty if you leave it somewhere for a while? When I was eight, I used to have two... Nope. I shit myself at school. High school! I was 17. I made up a lie about stepping on dog shit on the way to school as an excuse for the smell, and I went home. I recently told my best friend what happened, and she laughed at me because they had all believed me. I still don't know how they didn't figure what happened. When I was 10, I would purposefully wet the bed at night, so I didn't have to get up to go to the bathroom because I didn't want my parents to know I was up past my bedtime playing on my Kindle. The mattress never got cleaned because I never told anyone I was doing it. I think it might have been given away. Might have even been given away. God. You soiled that thing. This person confessed to me at 2 a.m. while we were laying around in my bed. Well, another friend, it was supposed to be a group hangout. And I got so terrified, I told her I wouldn't make her happy, and then she went to sleep and I went and threw up from anxiety. We are not winning, gay community. One time when I was 7, I went over to my cousin's house and played around with her. You motherfuckers and rabbits. I swear to God. I swear to God. Kids, like, fucking, if you're below the age of, like, 12, you should not be around a rabbit, apparently. It's always rabbits. Why is it always rabbits? What did they do to you? What did they do to my Twitch chat? If you guys saw Springtrap, what would you do to him? What would you do to him if you saw him? I'm never letting him around you. I'm never bringing him on stream. Never again. Holy fuck. I cannot trust him around you. Good fucking God. Like 4 or 5 years ago, I once sneezed so hard my tampon came shooting out like a missile while I was in class. Never ran out of a classroom so fast in my life. I didn't even ask to leave. When I went back in, I then had to explain to my 50-something-year-old merit teacher, I just almost shot a tampon out of me. As someone who does not have a vagina, relatable. I was at a party at my aunt's and I was addicted to eating a food she made and it was fish. And I ate two, so my mom was like, don't eat anymore. Then I stole one, went down into the basement, ate half of it before my mom started coming down. So I hid it in a closet. My aunt didn't find it for like 2 months. God. A lot of this is like, a lot of these gross ones are just hiding food and it gets stuck there. One time I saw a dead fish in my old little snapping turtle's tank and took it out and put it on a little lid and I just absolutely crushed it to pieces and I got scared that my mom would yell at me. Just farted. So I hid it behind a chair in my room for a week and a half and I threw it down the toilet. Why didn't you just do that sooner? Like, you could have done it the first chance you got. When I was little, I was once shopping for meat with my dad and I pointed at a dead pig and I said, and I quote, but I said, look, Dad, they killed a pig and chopped him up. Was I stable as a kid? No, you're literally just observing the existent world around you. This is not even a confession. This is just like, huh, that happened. When I was in third grade, there's a kid who kept slaying the R slur, and I was annoyed about it. So in class, I started crying, saying it's not something to joke about since one of my brothers has Down syndrome. The people near me gave me a hug and a tissue, and the teacher made him apologize. I mean, that sucks, but it's not much of a confession. Like, what about this is you confessing about something you did? Yeah, someone kept saying the R slur, and I was like, I didn't like that very much. Like, valid, I guess? Like, but I'm not sure why that fits in this. My cousin deleted my Minecraft world that I had from 2016 and said it was a joke. I then took his phone, used his face to unlock it when he was asleep, to look up very bad things people were doing, and told on him to my dad. He was sent to this camp, and then he comes back. I'm going to tell him it's a joke. That was not equivalent exchange. That's not equivalent exchange. I don't know if you know what they do to people at those camps. If it's the type of camp I'm thinking about where they, like, take you away and then they, like, do some correctional shit, that is not equivalent exchange. Like, it's funny that you retaliated super hard for deleting your Minecraft world, but, like, part of me wants to giggle, but part of me is like, fuck, I know what happens to people there. They get, like, left with lifelong trauma, and if this is real, that kid's actually gonna be fucked. I don't know. It's still kind of funny. I despise Kanye, like, hate him. I'm not even gonna give you the time of day. Like, you don't. I don't like him as a person. Don't want to give him clout. What do you mean you don't want to give Kanye clout? What fucking clout could you give Kanye West? What fucking clout could you, dude? Don't act like Kanye. Like, there's anything you could give Kanye. Come on now. Let's not. Oh, that's so funny. I was on the family computer and the internet stopped. He's worth $5 billion. He makes music for fun now. You can hate Kanye and, like, fair. I hate a lot of the shit he does too. What do you mean give Kanye clout? I was on the family computer and the internet stopped working, so I called my dad. When he didn't come to my room, I went to his and my mom's room. Yeah. I used to have this friend in kindergarten. We'll call her Kay. She's older than me. One time she's at my house and we were playing a game. We were both right next to the washer. She picked up one of my dad's socks and fucking pissed in it. She wasn't allowed over again. Yeah, I can see why. Another pissed in a place you shouldn't piss in. Hi, Heavenly Father. Sorry this is the stream you're dropping in on. It's been brutal. It's been a brutal one. You need to be a man of character, which I have in spades to make it through this. My sister once put a friend of my parents' dog in one of those again, with the animals and the washing machines. What is it with you people? Somebody could make, like, a compilation of every time, like, a Kwite viewer has admitted to, like, fucking mutilating an animal or one of their pets on stream. Oh, good God. When I was 6, I opened up one of my older siblings' nail polish bottles and poured them all out in my room. I then blamed it on my little sister because I thought it would get her kicked out of the house. Obviously, she didn't get kicked out, and I don't think anyone knows that I did it. Yeah, whatever. At a party in April I was invited to, I was messing around with an iron skillet pan and shattered someone's wall-length mirror. They still have no idea it was me. I used to steal stuff from other kids when I was in middle school, and nobody thought it was me because I was the good kid. I wasn't a bully, but I wasn't a great student. Playing teacher's pet paid off, and I actually passed my classes. Nice. Used to be a cat kid and would scratch people when I got mad. Hurry! And would gaslight them and cry whenever they said. They would try to tell the teacher because I was also a gifted kid and was afraid of consequence. The funny thing is it worked every time, and they'd comfort me after. Professional gaslighter. Emotional manipulation at an early age. Every time I visit my cousin at her house and she leaves me alone for more than 5 minutes, I lick one of her salt lamps. I've been doing this over the course of 12 years. I've gotten it down to half its original size. She still hasn't noticed. I'm going to lick it until it's gone. That's dedication. Like, I can't even, like, be mad at that. That's real commitment to a bit. That's more commitment to a bit than most people will have in their life. That is... I wish you recorded that entire thing. That would be so funny to watch as a time lapse. I have a tradition, like, one of the funniest things I've ever read. I hope that's real. Like, on God, I hope that's real. I have a tradition that on school trips, banned or otherwise, if we stop at a hotel I must jerk off in the shower, even if I'm sharing the bathroom with other people. It's the only time I ever really jerk off, but none of my other roommates have ever found out. Should I tell them? No. 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 You should just... Like, so you're telling me you don't even, like, jerk off for pleasure's sake? You do it specifically because you're in a, like, you're sharing a hotel room with people. I can't with y'all. The logic puzzles are incredible. A couple of things when I was very little. I would need to pee in the middle of the night, but I didn't want my mom or grandparents to wake up and know I was awake. My solution was to pee on the rug and blame it on the dog, who wasn't quite house trained. Yeah, we've seen that before. When I was 6 or 7, I stomped on my sister's V area. I was thinking, she ain't got no dick or balls, so it won't hurt. I did that for like 2 minutes straight before I see her silent crying from the pain she just endured from me. Please forgive me. I could use like a cigarette right about now, you know? Like just like I could one pull a cigarette right now. Just let me you know, maybe I have one on me. Come on, please tell me I have a pack somewhere. I could really use this shit right about now. Oh, there it is. Much better. Shit's so bad, I need a ciggy. Oh, God. When I was 10, I went into my mom's room and found her a sex... I didn't know what it was, but I knew where it went. It felt good, so I used it. Thanks for the Prime sub. Thanks for the Prime sub. When I was in fourth grade, my class was going down the hall to the library or something, and I really, really had to piss, but didn't think I'd make it to the bathroom, and so I pissed on the carpet in the classroom and convinced my teacher that someone must have spilled something. Nice. I've eaten so many things that should have killed me. I have eaten chalk, nail polish remover, Sharpie, perfume, and probably so much more. My family house has a creek behind it, and I found a turtle near it. I played with this turtle all day, and at the end, I put him back in the creek. I came back the next day. My turtle friend, but actually my tortoise friend, had drowned, and it was all my fault. Thanks for the sub, Tulip. That's like the Vine. When I was around 5 years old, I had a rather large plastic bin for toys. One day, and my cousin came over, and I ended up putting the bin in on top of her and sitting on the bin, and she passed out. I thought she died and dragged her outside and left her close to the woods. You know, whenever I feel judged by chat, or like whenever chat makes me feel like even a little bad about something, I just have to remember these streams. I just have to like, I just have to remember that you fuckers are in here. And I'm like, these are the people who are talking down to me. And it becomes better. It makes my life a little better. I was 5 and I was on my little demon shit phase. And my mom got pissed at me while I was holding the dog because I got really mad. I threw the dog at... I have pretended to be bisexual for the longest time because people don't take straight ace people too kindly in the LGBT community. But I've realized I'm actually a trans gay ace man, so I won't suffer that anymore. Transphobia, on the other hand. I'm sorry, I hope you figure it out. When I got my period for the first time, it was on my boyfriend's lap. And when he asked what it was, I told him it was Kool-Aid. I'm gonna ignore the slash J, because that's funny. When I was in 6th grade, I went to the beach with my dad's football team for the end of a party. It makes me sick to remember, but I was in the water, and one of my dad's football players asked me if he could... No. When I was 11, I've read and enjoyed a Donald Trump ex-reader fanfic graphic smut. Why couldn't you have just capped it there? You didn't have to go into detail. Name of the 100 bits, arsonist. I used to tell my bio dad I hated him for like 25 cents from his shitty roommate. I mean, he kind of deserved it because it
Dude, what? Usually, why is it so many in a row?
I can take like one or two of these types of things like an hour. And then I my skin is deteriorating. I'm physically disintegrating the longer the stream goes on, man. In my freshman year of high school, me and my friends would cover one specific window in milk every morning. When the janitors cleaned it, we decided that it was a direct attack and started covering multiple windows in milk. That's the whole confession. That's funny. That's funny. When I was little, me and some other kids brought soap to school. During recess, we thought it would be reasonable to mix it with snow. When a teacher caught us, they told everyone that innocent fish in the ocean would die because of our actions. No, they won't. Don't listen to the teacher. Do it again. Don't let them stop you next time. When I was 7, my dad was in the shower, and I really needed to piss, and we had a dog who was not trained, so we had a pee pad. So I pissed on the pee pad on the floor a little bit, and my dad found out. Never found out. And I never told anyone this until now. Can pee pads, like, can dog pee pads handle human pee? Like, or is the things that compose our pee fundamentally different? Like, I'm curious, is this a viable alternative if there's not an available bathroom? Is it? They can? This is a fucking game changer, dude. This is a game changer. Holy shit. They work just fine. I think they just absorb li- It didn't- Dude, I didn't realize they were like multi-purposed like that, though. When I was little, me and my cousin would ha- Nope. No. I have really done anything, but I genuinely think about bashing my siblings' heads in a lot. Please see a therapist. I like to suck on toes, but I like doing it. I tell everyone around me how gross feet are. Thank you for the 1,000 bits, so Sowofi. Appreciate it. And to keep them away from me, but in reality, I just like sucking in toes. I tried it once, and I haven't stopped thinking about it. Thanks for the 50 bits. I chased my little sister around with a knife with my friend. She climbed out her window onto the roof to escape, so I locked her out there. For reference, it was December, and she didn't get back in until 2:30 when my little brother let her in. Odd. One time in gym, we went outside, and my friend threw a big-ass rock at my face, and I let out a blood-curdling scream, which the gym teacher didn't hear. And to this day, my mom doesn't know it was my friend, and I still talk to her on a daily basis. I hope you got a rock back in, at least. Like you got a hurl in retaliation. Ugh. I don't like going places with my mom, like, at all. She'll ask me where we should go for school breaks, and I'll tell her I want to stay home. But if my dad asks, I'll usually say yes without a thought. Also, my mom has full custody of me. I think if you prefer your dad's custody, the older you get, you may have some say on, like, who you would, like, spend more time with. I don't know, though. I don't know if that's only decided once when, like, the initial divorce happens. I'm not sure. I almost stabbed my babysitter because she was dating my dad and abused me. I was 8 and didn't know why I felt like doing it, but then I cried because I realized literal murder is insane. I hope now, though, still that... I mean... If she is abusing you, like, fair play, I'd say. Murder is on the table. I like scrolling through political slash controversial Facebook posts. Any racist slash misogynistic slash god-awful comments I see, I'll look at the profile, and if the work is connected, I'll report them. Been doing it for a few years now, no regrets. That's petty on another level. Just farted. That's petty on another level. It's not even people you know, it's just anybody you see along those lines. Sometimes I do little trolling, but shut. Not even gonna try it. When I was 6 or 5, I once punched my mom square in the nose because she made fun of me. When I realized what I did, I was shit scared out of my mind. We got over it, and it's forgotten by now. I don't think God is gonna forgive me. One time, my brother and I shared bedroom. I was jacking off in the middle of the night. I saw him wake up, and we made contact while I was still jerking it. I don't know, I'm thinking, hold on, once I shaved my pubes at midnight and it was my grandfather's face trimmer. Felt so bad, but I sterilized it with alcohol, then scrubbed it with diluted hydrogen peroxide. Guys, I really want to end, but we still have 1,000 viewers. Like, we still have, we can't. Just farted. So when I was around the age of 5, my family had these angels that hold candlesticks, and I wanted to see one up close and dropped it, so I got scared and ran away. Still wondering what my parents thought about it, Sugar Star. Oh, God. Thank you for the Prime sub, JoJo Flame, appreciate it. Oh, God. Where do we submit these? You can't. You can't. You can stop, it's alright. You don't know what's alright. You don't understand. It pisses me off how you waste farts by not catching them in the jar. I have an automated system that bottles them for me. Because I work smarter, not harder. One time when I was a kid, my friend said that she wanted to save Cat, like the real one, because she thinks that... Thanks for the Prime sub, Ruiz. Thanks for the 200 bits. I slap it right, appreciate it. Once as a kid, my mom told me there was a turd on the ground. Me being a dumb child and not knowing what a turd was, I decided to go over to it, and dumb child me decided to give it a taste. So I did. I ate dog shit, literally. You ate shit. Sometimes I pretend not to hear what people say, even though I do. I kind of want to stop, but I feel like I'm just conditioned to now always say what or huh whenever my family members say something to me at dinner that I hear. I will legit have people say things, and I will instinctively say huh or what, and then after I say what, it's given me the 1 second I need to process what they're saying. It'll be like, what? Oh, yeah. Or like, what? Oh, yeah. And then I'll, like, finish the thought. Is it weird if I find Enderman attractive? No, I agree. Like, I can't help but fantasize about Endermen sometimes. My heart flutters thinking about them, and the sounds they make are so cute. I think there's something wrong with me. No, that's perfectly reasonable. I purposely threw my dad's Xbox 360 when he asked me to clean his closet while I was sick. Also threw away his chess set and fleshlight? Listen, one of these is not like the other. I don't know why he kept that in there. Should have let me rest while I was sick. I've dreamed about killing my cousin who traumatized me. Last time I dreamt when you hit 100k. Mommy Moth is actually so fucking cute, like not even a sex way, like blushing. I think that once I'm off to college and can finally embrace my sexuality, most of my family will shun me. I hope it goes well for you. When I was 7, I used to eat tiny pieces of toilet? That's a new consumable item. Also, when I was 7, I accidentally swallowed my gum and then chugged a bunch of apple juice because I thought if I didn't, I would probably die or something. Who made up the lie that gum takes 7 years to digest? Who was the evil bastard who spread that thing if you swallow gum? Not really an insane or silly entry, but here, there's a possibility I might be slightly misogynistic, as I have a bad habit of thinking everyone I meet is going to hurt me in some way. I am working on it. I mean, that's all anybody can ask. Everybody's got their preconceived biases they gotta work through. And that's about any, that can be like any number of things. It's just a matter of like trying to work on it. Okay, so I know it's not much because I was a good kid and still am. Okay, boring. A friend jokingly took my phone, so I'm fighting and wrestling them to get it back. And there I am, right on top of them, on their house in their bed. Anyways, our families think we are having sex. We are not. Oh, that's literally the setup for like some fucking cartoon, dude. I was at a Krispy Kreme and really needed to use the bathroom, so I went to the single-person bathroom, but someone was already in there, so I went outside and shat in some bushes because I couldn't wait anymore. the consequence of eating Krispy Kreme. When I was in third grade, my older cousin found out what sex was. She would what kind of cartoon? It's like one of those fucking jokes that adults who are making the show will sneak in that kids won't get. Like a character will walk in on two characters like in like a compromising position. The child won't understand it, but the adult who's forced to watch with them will be like, I get it. Why is there so much incest? I don't know. What? I don't know. What about my content attracts this type of shit? What am I doing? God damn it. One time when I was 7, my dad got a pet fish. I thought it was supposed to be mine, So I was like, well, I don't want this stupid ass fish, and decided to flush it down the toilet and only got in mild trouble. This one isn't that bad, but I thought I'd give you a not so bad sin knowing chat. I stole a stuffed bear, it's rainbow, from my first grade teacher, and I have no memory of how I did it. I never gave it back. Thanks for the breather. It's appreciated. You're a good fella. No. When I was younger, my mom would leave me alone with her birds a lot, and I watched the documentary that sometimes baby birds need to be sat on by their mother. See, this is like animals getting hurt, but it's like the dumbass kid version of kids getting hurt. Like, well-intentioned, just kill the small animal. I probably shouldn't have been left alone with the birds. When my teacher needed help grading finals, I always gave the trouble kids a second chance to fix the wrong answers because I didn't want them to fail, and I'm not supposed to do that as a teacher's aide. You're the G. The dark gothic music ended again. My old dog pooped in my closet, so I gave it to my older brother. He died, and my two hamsters, Mario and Luigi, threw their poop on my bed, so I gave them to my brother. They both died. I was very young. At least you weren't the one killing the animals directly this time, I guess? When I was in high school, I used to file my nails into points so I could scratch people when they annoyed me. Side note, it wasn't strangers. They were my friends. They were just annoying sometimes. I ate dog crap because I thought it was funny a couple years ago, you and everybody else in this chat. I think there is something wrong with me. Apparently not, considering how many others there are. Once convinced my friend at school I was a vampire because I have sharp canine teeth, yellow eyes, and pale skin. I'm still not 100% convinced that he believed me or was just pretending to pity me. I'm gonna assume pity. Yo, I'm Ash. Why did you say your name? Why would you say your name in the anonymous confession? One time I told a child at an indoor bounce house to go say very non-kid friendly things to his word, say it was secret code word. I was also a kid, just an older kid, kind of feeling sorry for him. This is the kind of power tripping like fucking slightly older kids will do to slightly younger kids. I used to get gender envy from Shark Boy, from the hot movie Shark Boy and Lava Girl featuring hit actor George Lopez. Also realized I'm just a gay dude and not bisexual thanks to Genshin fan art. Do you see the problem here? Do you see the problem area? Like, we have all of this, and then we have the issue. We have found the problem. Am I correct? Like, I won't lie, when I was like 7 or 8, I wanted to be Shark Boy. That motherfucker was cool as hell. Like, any young boy wants to be like Shark Boy. He was cool. He was the shit. But you're gonna follow up this very relatable dude guy thing with this? Nah. Unacceptable. I gave myself carpal tunnel syndrome caused by playing Friday Night Funkin' every day, multiple hours a day for over a year. Oh my god, this is literally me. This guy's just like me for real. I just wanted to get out my own self-plight because there was ample opportunity here. Most sane Genshin player, real. I will literally never like Genshin Impact. I'm not gonna lie, I might do it a one-off for a stream just so I can, because you guys enjoy me in pain for some reason. Friday Night Funkin' disease, that's how it is. I would try to break my leg to get out of PE. It never worked because I was too scared to actually go through with it. Oh, and I almost stabbed my brother once, but that's not important. You're gonna change your mind real quick. Nah, I bet you'll like it. I played Genshin if it wasn't bad. See, even if I liked Genshin, I don't even think it's something that would stick. It just doesn't seem like the genre that I really play for fun. The characters, at least? I mean, maybe. I'm sorta uncomfortable with my dad getting a girlfriend, and I don't know why. My mom isn't married to him, and the co-parenting situation is fine, but I haven't seen his girlfriend, and I don't know about it. I mean, I guess it's fine to feel like kind of a way about it because it does affect your life in a really significant way. But also it's like, I don't know. I've never been in a co-parenting situation, so it's kind of hard for me to speak on those issues. When I was around 10 to 11, I developed a massive porn addiction. One day I wondered why there were no videos of people like... This is how I learned Ashton Kutcher catching child predators. Awesome! I'm awesome! When I was younger, maybe 12, some girl called me the next Hitler because I liked Edgar Allan Poe. I said that if... Oh my god. My sibling literally got stabbed through the stomach with a rock, and I walked up to my mom when they told me to get her, and Com said, sibling fell into the creek. I was like 7 when this happened. Struggling with where I am on the aromantic spectrum. I hope you figured it out. I would buy gifts for a lot of my friends in hopes that I can talk to them and talk to me, that they won't leave me. They always left. Also, I almost broke someone's nose in a sport. I don't want to talk about it. I hear my parents have sex very often. They once even brought me home early from school when I was sick and were doing it on the couch 20 minutes later. So I was never there. Super weird, not gonna lie. It is weird. When I was in elementary school, I pushed a girl down the stairs. She had a broken arm. I caught her before she slipped the stairs, and because I did that, I got free ice cream because I saved her. You made the problem and then half solved it and got rewarded. I went to a sleepover with my crush when I was 12, and I cut off a bit of her hair, and I wrapped it up with one of her shirts and took it home with me. I still have it 9 years later. You're telling me you're grown, 21 years old. You did this when you were 12, and you kept it the entire time. Like a full decade later, like, modern warfare has completed and been rebooted in the time since you did this shit. There have been 4 Call of Duty Black Ops releases since you did this, and you still have it. Like, please tell me you just have it out of laziness. Like, you put it somewhere and just never moved it because there was never, like, motivation to. Please tell me. Please tell me it's not an active thing that you, like, hold on to. Please tell me. I once invited a kid into my house. He was riding the bike I used to ride and backed into a step with the metal sides, and the metal went through the back of his head and needed stitches. That's not really a confession. Like, that's not something you did, is it? That's just, like, a freak accident. That one was gross. I'm not even gonna read that out loud. When I was little, I shipped Dora and Diego together and had a crush on Swiper. I also had a crush on Withered Bonnie. That's not that weird. When FNAF 2 came out, and then Jeff the Killer shortly after. Unfortunately, also not that weird. Ugh. My mom always laughed at me when I'd cry around her, and it fucked up my ability to accept love. So I always get horny when anyone is nice to me! Awesome. Congrats on the praise kink. It's gonna be a problem, I imagine. I pushed my little brother down the stairs on purpose. She's okayed now, sadly, but it was justified. He tattled on me, and I got the metal hanger, so I feel like it's a fair trade. Why are you blaming your brother for the parents who abused you? I feel like... That's the thing, like, with kids. They, like, in situations like that, they will view the parents as, like, forces of nature and blame shit that, like, shouldn't have happened to them on, like, the cause and effect that happened before that. Like, the next closest thing they can actually do something to lash out about. Like, it doesn't help shit. God. Don't hit your kids. It doesn't do shit. I don't care if, I don't care who you are. Don't fucking hit your kids. If you hit your kids, you're a piece of shit. Like, fuck you. Last Halloween, my girlfriend threw a party at her place, and I went. We all had some drinks, and long story short, I kissed her brother, and since then we've been hooking up. With her brother? With her brother? Your girlfriend's brother? I'm telling you, for your sake, you better hope that love triangle does not complete. You better hope it does not. Sometimes when I watch your streams, I start, like, simping for you, but I, like, control my... No. when I was a kid, I watched something or saw my parents doing, I think you know, so from like 5 to 10, I would piss on a doll. It got taken away because it started to smell weird. One time, me and my brother were playing with Nerf guns and we were waving around, and then I hit a window in my room and we didn't get in a lot of trouble for some reason. I've watched your streams while driving home more than once, had my phone mounted so I can glance over and watch while watching traffic. Listen, if you're gonna have my streams on while you drive, please just treat it like a podcast, okay? But listen, if you absolutely gotta do that, just treat it like a podcast, please. 11 to 14-ish, I had a horrible constipation, so I would shit, pick it up with toilet paper, and throw it away with the bathroom garbage. I've grown up, but it still haunts my dreams. I don't know, that just sounds like hard. I hope your asshole is doing better these days. Yeah, I hope your bowels pass a little easier. One time in the first grade, I stole my best friend's pencil pouch because I thought it was cute and watched her cry about it for like a week until I felt bad and gave it back. When I was 5, I had a piss bucket that I'd hide under the bed I shared with my mother? Wait, did you share the bed or the piss bucket? She would tell me if I thought the room smelled weird. I never got caught though, W. I'm not gonna lie to you, she probably knew. To some degree, she probably knew. When I was 5, I would hang on my legs, another time I also put one of them in my pants. Anyway, no. I've had constant visions and hallucinations of killing people, and I still think pushing people down the stairs would be a bit funny. I also think you are really cool. And what does that say about my content? What does that say about me? Please, reach out to folks. There's resources for these things, my man. You don't have to do this alone. Promise. Oh, God. I need an ad break. I've earned an ad break. One time I had left a whole chocolate bar out in the sun, proceeding to leave my dog outside. The dumbass dog then ate the bar and threw up so much he died. I thought that as a young kid, Funtime Freddy from Sister Location was hot. Admitting you liked FNAF animatronics is not that bad of a confession. Considering it's happened multiple times with different animatronics, and when you compare it to all the other ones, and considering whose stream you're confessing it on. I wanted to date him, I just remember that, and I want to cry because I'm remembering it. I threw my Kwite plush out my window in rage one day, and when I ran outside to get him, I was crying and saying, "Sorry, I think I have a problem with attachments." I mean, I appreciate it. Thanks for thinking of me, I guess. Like, saying sorry for, like, feeling bad. I forgive you, I think. I quote, "It's so weird being called by my second channel name. I forget, a lot of people only know me from there." Maybe that... I'm poor and live in a very bad home life. It's not necessarily a sin, but I cry every day. Maybe that's something someone can laugh at. Is this a cry for help? Listen, there's literally nothing I can do because you submitted this anonymously, but if you need help, please just tell you someone you trust, please. When I was younger, I would play 24-hour videos of jump scares, FNAF jump scares, on school computers and close them so that when someone opened it, the jump scare would play. Okay, that's funny. That's funny. That's funny. That one's funny. Yeah, I gotta make a no trauma dumping rule, man. I gotta make it an official guideline. I don't have anything too bad, but I told my mom my stomach hurt to get out of swim practice. Two one too many times, and you got your thyroid meds changed because of it. I've never played FNAF or watched someone play it because I'm too scared of it, but I know some of the fucking lore. It's actually embarrassing. I've not beaten a single FNAF game, but I have watched so many analytical videos on FNAF because I'm obsessed with it as a franchise. Like, I unironically fuck with the lore so much, but I've never beaten a single FNAF game in my life. I have, like, probably single digits hours of gameplay on FNAF. Like, at least from before I streamed it. Like, I just love the whole thing as an aesthetic. I couldn't tell you. I do like the VR game a lot, actually. I thought of driving into incoming... Please talk to a therapist. I think that it's actually... I'm not doing it. I'm not even going to start with that. I once purposely gave my friend poisonous food. They're okay now. I pushed my then 3-year-old brother off the top of my loft bed into a laundry basket. Once when I was on vacation, I was so sleep deprived, I went up to a random family at the beach thinking it was mine. This happened 2 years ago, I was 16. I sold my sister's dolls because a school project, I also explained how you can make... I'm in the metal family fandom, I don't know what that is. I used to eat plain tortillas and they used to be refrigerated as well, but that's only because my mom would never feed me. Anyone else ever eat plain tortillas? Sometimes if I wanted a snack, I would eat like an untoasted raw tortilla. I just like I was like the texture of the tortilla just hit for some reason. When I was 7, nope. I think the worst thing I've ever done was stab my brother in the head with my favorite fork and then eat with said fork. I found a piece of gum under a bunch of dirt and wood chips when I was like 5 or so and ate it. You didn't even just chew on it, you just straight up ate it. Not too big, but I've completed Sonic Mania, all the Chaos Emeralds 5 times, but I refuse to beat Encore Mode. That was a post made by Naxathan. Told my little brother to lick the outside of the freezer and he had to rip it off because it got stuck. Now he can't taste things at the tip of his tongue. You saw that shit on Home Alone and was like, this would be a great video idea. Had my first kiss when I was 6, and it was with my cousin. Awesome. It wasn't made by me. I've beaten more times than that. Best. I've always almost pissed myself on the bus more than I remember. Once I slightly did. And some other time, my older brother told me to pee in his water bottle. Your older brother was trying to mislead you. He knew it would overflow. He knew exactly how that would go. I had somebody else's hair stuck on my feet, and I have just been able to remove it. How do I know it's not mine? It's red. I have black and blonde hair. Okay, listen. You already have two different types of hair color. Like, what's one more? What's one more, like, color of hair in that mix? All right, let's be honest. I dropped a kitten that was nope. I accidentally put my cat in the trash. Almost threw him into our... You're an idiot. You're an idiot. You're an idiot. You're an idiot. You did it more than once? You did it more than once? I have been sincerely lusting over Futanari girls, and well, it has taken my life to the point I want one. I need one. Oh, father, what shall I do? I don't know. Cry? I realize I'm into tasers when I asked my now fiance what the black thing was in his pockets. He turned to the taser, and I was never the same. Good God. Good God. So happy birthday. No. Had a crush on Sonic, Justin Bieber, and Raphael from TMNT and used to read Mpreg. We don't go down that path anymore. See, cross this one out. Valid. Valid. No comment. I'm decent at rhythm games. My friends insist that I'm a loser and get no play. Which is true. Do I go to hell for being good at rhythm games? For the like, you're going to hell for a couple reasons, but for the most part, that's why. Once dated a necro. Broke up with them as soon as I found out. I don't know what they're doing now, but whatever it is, I hope it doesn't involve the dead. I accidentally put soap in my friend's drink instead of syrup because it was the same color. Single-handedly obliterated 3 high school relationships all over one or once over a rumor. Okay, I think these are personally drying up. And we have been going for some time now. I think we've streamed for a substantial amount of time, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna do an outro. Guys, did you know if you watched this on YouTube, you missed out on, honestly, just having your soul crushed live? We could have used your emotional support here. The more people there are, the easier it is to get through this. I'm not even kidding. Twitch.tv/Kwite, we'd love to have you. God. Monday, Wednesday, Friday, baby. Okay, the recording's over. I am in pain at all hours of the day. Listen, I'm just gonna run the ad break and then I'm just gonna raid someone. I can't do the pleasantries, man. I'm in so much pain. Hey YouTube, I'm literally dying? What the fuck? Who's even live, man? Aerith's live. Just give it to Aerith, man. Just give it to Aerith. I haven't seen the fella in a minute. Oh, he's AFK, goddammit. You know, I still want to raid Aerith, so I'm just going to, like, wait till he gets back. Here's what I'll do. We'll raid Aerith when he gets back, but in the meantime, we can do a funny little Q&A meme. Stay for the raid, but, like, I'll answer some questions if you want before we, like, head off. Oh God, I love Aerith. Yeah, he's a swell fella. Love that guy. Oh, they're back. Perfect. Literally as the ad break ended. Motherfucker's eating salad. Okay, I expect every single one of y'all to be in this goddamn raid. If you're not, I'll literally cry. After what I went through tonight, don't you guys think you owe me being in this? Don't you guys think I deserve y'all being in this raid? Because I think I do. I think I do. I think I've earned it. I think I've earned you guys sticking around for a raid. Please. 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 Fuck! I can't do this. I'm emotionally compromised. I'll see you on Monday. I'll see you on Monday, you little shits.
I don't really like eating on camera. It feels weird. Do you mind if we just chill like this for a bit? Oh, Kwite, bro! How you doing, my boy? I don't know why I'm calling you my boy. I don't think we're that close friends, but I appreciate you. We met in person at VidCon. Kwite's really cool, if you don't know him. I talked about him earlier because someone came over from your stream. Like, I just came over from Kwite's stream. How you doing? Thank you so much for the raid. Hope you're doing so well. Hope you had a great stream. What was Kwite streaming? We just had a little break. I got a salad here, so I was going to go on my PNG tuber a little bit while I eat my salad. But we are doing a Minecraft hardcore thing. I have never done Minecraft hardcore before, somehow, even though Minecraft is like the main thing I do. We've got the Minecraft Championships tomorrow, which I'm competing in, which is, if anyone doesn't know, the largest Minecraft competition currently running at the moment. Or the largest Minecraft competition ever. Who are you? You seem familiar. Not sure why I would seem familiar. If you know the Dream SMP, I'm on there. Hi, Goose. He wants my salad. I'm going to say goodbye to my salad because I've been streaming for 5 hours and I'm really hungry. What team you on? I'm on the Orange Ocelots, which is me, Finster, Quig, who's insanely good at Minecraft, and in the Little Wood, also known as Mossy. Quite said something. Doing chat confessions was a struggle. Oh god, what was the worst? Sorry, I'm gonna go to the PNG tuber a bit because I wanna eat my food. Sorry, Goose is not gonna be in there. Unless I can hide behind Goose. And you can just enjoy seeing the back of his head. Oh. What's these songs? If you want the playlist, you can just do playlist. Exclamation mark playlist. So I'm gonna go to this because I. What were the worst confessions you got? I need to know. I feel like eating on camera is. I think it's appropriate to say in your stream. Dude, I swear on my stream all the time, don't worry. I say bad shit, don't worry. I'm not a family friendly stream. At least not that friendly, family friendly. So much incest? What? No! No! Goose, stop trying to eat my salad. Damn. These can't all be real, right? Murder, incest, and pit. Okay, well, I'm not sure what I was expecting when I asked what's the worst. Fair. Goose, you're a cat. I'm not sure you can eat this salad. He keeps reaching his paw for my fucking salad. Sorry, I would try to get back into the game right now. This would be interesting to watch at least. But I'm very hungry. Eric, I'm straight for you. Well, I'm gender fluid, so if anyone likes me, it makes you gay. That's the rule. That's... Yeah, everyone's gay. Sorry, he's so fucking soft. Goose, we got him as a stray cat a year ago, and he's become so soft, I love him. Queers, all of you, you are gay! I'm kidding. Sorry, I will... Have you played Stray yet? I'm gonna go back to the PNG tube, but I don't have a button on my thing yet. Eric, a little wolf says... Why are these things so far behind? Always happy to give you my support. Been sick of the flu lately. Your stream's been real comfort during it.
Aha, I see.
Sorry that took longer than I planned. I had like technical difficulties before I started.
It's all good. It's Friday. No worries.
Dude, that was
at least on my end.
I was doing chat confessions tonight, and it was like, yeah, I've done this twice before, and it was some of the worst ones I've ever gotten.
How many psychopaths did you get, or edgelords?
We got double digits animal abusers.
Several, my god!
People who got to take advantage of. By their cousins for like sexual purposes. There was a lot of pissing stuff, which was on the tame end, honestly. Like when I saw a P1, I was like, oh thank god, compared to the other shit.
It sounds like it was a good stream.
I can't wait for the video.
Let's go.
The worst part is like they kind of like do well, and I think they come out really funny like after all the editing's been done.
Oh my goodness!
Fair enough.
I need to That's make a rule genius. Against trauma dumping though. Like I need to state that.
Yeah.
Because I have to scroll past so many people like talking about like I kind of want to like kill myself, and I'm like, please don't do that.
Yeah.
Okay, let me go offline real quick. And then everybody go get snacks.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, I was going to say, obviously, you're seeing the visual novel aspect, which you are, I'm sure, used to. I was going to say, what do you think about the gameplay itself?
Oh, it looks cool. I think the environment gets a little bit stale. It's kind of just all the same looking, but I've only seen play the game a couple of times, so that could definitely change. But, like, the gameplay itself looks fun.
Environment.
What's up?